Some of you young folks been saying to me, "Hey, Pops, what you mean, what a wonderful world? How about all them wars all over the place? You call them wonderful? And how about hunger and pollution? They ain't so wonderful either. But how about listening to old Pops for a minute? Seems to me it ain't the world that's so bad, but what we are doing to it. And all I'm saying is, see what a wonderful world it would be if only we'd give it a chance. Love, baby, love. That's the secret. Yeah. If lots more of us loved each other, we'd solve lots more problems. And man, this world would be a guesser. That's why old Pops keeps saying,
the stream. Welcome, welcome. Pilot Fisk, welcome to the chat. Hope you're doing well, buddy. Good to see you. We're back with some more flight sim action again today. Let me just sort the volume levels out here real quick. Yeah, so welcome to the chat, Martin, as well. Welcome. Enjoy your flight, dude. Enjoy your flight. All right. Good evening, everybody. Gabrielle, Acer, Manacle. Welcome to the chat, everyone. Hope we're all doing well. Welcome, welcome, welcome. What a great intro. Yeah. Yeah, it's fantastic, that video. It's fantastic. It's not mine. I'll put a link in the chat once again. If you want to go and check that out, leave a thumbs up on the video as well. It's by Yen Studio on YouTube. Fantastic video that I think I played it last stream. Can't get enough of it. So yeah, go check it out, guys. Go check it out. All right, so today we are going to be flying from Zurich, from the relatively newly released scenery that was done for the Game of the Year edition. Excuse me. That was done for the Game of the Year edition by Gaia Simulations. Absolutely stunning scenery. Really like it. So looking forward to this. And we're going to be flying into Copenhagen, which is going to be the Fly Tampa scenery. As you guys probably well know, is by far one of my favorite sceneries for the simulator. So that one, yeah, always look forward to flying in there. And we should have a lot of VATSIM coverage today, because there is an event on here at Zurich. It actually officially starts in 10 minutes, but I thought, obviously, because, you know, I don't generally ramble on for quite a while before we actually do anything, I thought, let's get in there a little bit earlier. So the flight plan's filed, everything is all ready to go, and I'm looking forward to this. How are we all doing today? Chris, good afternoon, sir. Hope you're doing well. Welcome to the chat. All right, Shane as well. Thank you for the like on Facebook. Right then. I feel like I had something else to tell you guys before we get underway here, but I think it seems to have escaped me. So we're going to press on. All right, so here we are at Zurich. Like I said, the Gaia Simulations scenery, looking absolutely stunning. We've got Baijan's Seasons mod on as well, so it makes the trees look a bit darker, a bit more wintry. And as you can see, we've got quite a bit of traffic on the ground here already. I believe this runway is in use. Oh, this is runway 28. I've just seen a couple of aircraft take off from there, but they must have changed it. I think they are actually using... is it this one? So many runways here. 16 or 14 is what they're using. I've just realized how long runway 16 is. I've never realized that. That is one long runway, isn't it? Anyways, as you can see, there's a bit of traffic on the ground already. What have we got down here? We've got a Swiss Star Alliance A320. Looking very good. I think I might actually go through the AIG model matching and I might actually remove those Star Alliance liveries from my AIG model matching, because although they look nice, you don't really see them that often in real life, do you? And it seems to nearly match those like nearly all of the time. I can probably guarantee we'll see at least one more at some point. So we've got an Austrian 321 here. We've got a Eurowings 320. KLM 737, obviously. And then we've got another Swiss A320. And an Edelweiss 320 here as well. Looking very nice. We've got a couple of aircraft there that's not seemed to have matched properly. So I'm just going to be prudent here and just type in vpilot.aircraft and just see if I can find out which one that actually is. Okay, so there's a few here where people have used... okay, so it seems to have matched some biz jets with airliners for some reason. I'm not sure why. So this in the background here, this guy, I think he's a biz jet, and I think this one is also. I'll take a screenshot anyway, just so I can review that at a later date. All right, cool. Yeah, so, yeah, exactly, Chris, with the Star Alliance. It seems to match them quite often, doesn't it? And like I say, you don't really see them that often in real life, so it might be worth amending that. All right, and let's see. Here we are. We're down here, parked on stand 5-2. This is our beautiful SAS liveried CRJ today. This is actually a flight that is operated in the real world by a company called CityJet, and who operate, I believe, solely for Scandinavian Airlines, as you can see. Operated by CityJet here on the fuselage, and we're going to be using subsequently their call sign, which is City Island. I believe they're actually an Irish company. As you can see on the aircraft itself, the registration is EI, which I believe is Ireland. I'm pretty sure it is Ireland. So, There we have it. Another thing I changed as well between now and last stream is I actually changed on my graphics settings. I actually put the... Okay, I did actually put these down to 100 earlier on. But it seems to have changed again, but I'll do that now. And my reason for that is these two sliders use... versus all of the other settings here, I believe these are two of the most resource-intensive CPU side graphics options. And I find when I'm flying on VATSIM, I do tend to get quite a lot of stuttering and a much lower frame rate. And I believe that is due to the fact that, obviously, VPilot is injecting all the other aircraft into the sim. So, as a result, you end up with... a lower frame rate. So I'm tweaking those sliders down a bit with the hopes that I get a slightly smoother frame rate when I'm on VATSIM. We'll see how that works out. It might not really do anything, but we'll see how it works out anyway. And I think because when aircraft are injected into the sim, that is my methodology is that the injected aircraft are a CPU sort of intensive process. It's not really a GPU thing to a great extent. It's more of a CPU thing because obviously it's mainly aircraft position and what other functions they're doing rather than just rendering a plane. So by dropping those down, I hope that we can get a little bit of a better frame rate, but we shall see. It may just be something that's unavoidable, but for science. I've flown with a CRJ SAS from Copenhagen to Oslo. Amazing, Pilotfist. That's really cool. I actually did it wasn't Copenhagen. I did a flight out of Oslo yesterday, actually, with that new freeware scenery. Which came out for Oslo, which is really, really good. I actually flew from Oslo to Manchester with Scandinavian in the A320 just yesterday. That was pretty cool. But yeah, I've never flown on a CRJ. I would quite like to fly on a CRJ just to experience it. But from what I've learned is... from videos I've watched and pilots that I've heard talk about it, I don't think CRJ, it's not really the most comfortable airliner for passengers, apparently, I'm told. So maybe just to experience it. You're going to fly along in observer mode? Fair enough, dude. Fair enough. Fair enough. That sounds rather creepy. But no, man, we should do a fly along one day where we're doing where we do VATSIM and you guys maybe just copy what I'm saying or something like that, maybe. Because there's nothing to it, really. It's once you've done it a few times, as long as you just write down what you're going to say and what's been said to you and you kind of know what to expect. I think that's the hardest part, really, knowing what to expect. And once you know what to expect, you can kind of anticipate what they're going to tell you, and it makes it much easier. But yeah, maybe we should do a fly along one day. I remember I spoke to Aerosoft about it quite a while back when CRJ first released. We were going to do some kind of fly along where we speak to some controllers on VATSIM, and we actually sort of book out an airport for a time period, and we can all do a departure out there and an arrival. But anyway, enough waffling. Let's get things set up. So the aircraft is in a turnaround state, which is probably what it would be at this airport. I imagine they will probably come from Copenhagen, fly to Zurich and then fly back. Now, this is based on a real flight. SAS 610 is a real flight. And I actually looked it up on FlightAware. It's actually due to depart in a couple of hours, but it is a daily flight. And the last flight they did, which was last night, was this exact flight. So they actually left Zurich at gate Alpha 5-2, which is what we are at. Well, this is actually Charlie 5-2, but I think how it works at Zurich is... Yeah, I'm going to just waffle for a bit longer. Hope you don't mind. I think the way it works at Zurich is this. So you have these remote stands down here. You've got a few stands, and now I understand there is probably some kind of cargo operation going down on this end of the airport, but the way I understand it is that if you are at one of these gate numbers, I was actually looking on the Zurich website earlier on, and you know how various some airports will give you where all, like, an airport map and where all the gates are. So these stand numbers down here, these are all actually on the Zurich website as being from... they're actually from a little building on the end here. Now, I'm not sure which building it is. I thought, looking at the charts, there was another little bit here, but somewhere along this end of the airport anyway, all of those stands are sort of marked on the airport map. So I imagine probably what you'd do is you'd probably come down to this area. Can we actually go inside? No, we can't. You would come down to this area, and I imagine you would just get on a bus, and it'll take you around to these stands. I imagine that's what the case is. I might be wrong about that, but looking for another stand 5-2 that starts with... there is a stand 5-2, I believe, over at this end. But this is... These stands all start with an E, I believe. And I believe that's where all the Swiss flights depart from. Look at that. We've got an aircraft taking off. Or I might have just landed. Air Serbia. Love to see it. So I couldn't find any other stand numbers that relate to where this aircraft departed from on FlightAware, so I've got to assume that it's this one. So anyway, enough rambling, let's get this thing set up. F-14 man says I should do a live stream with the F-35. Yeah, maybe. I mean, I don't own the F-35, to be honest. And I mean, I'm not that into my military aviation. As much as I appreciate it, I'm not really that into the procedures and things like that. I like to sort of do things on the stream here that are quite sort of anchored in the real world in terms of procedures and... well, just general operation of the aircraft. And when it comes to military jets, I really have no idea where I'm going with that. So, yeah, maybe one day I will just do one. We have done a few streams in, I think we've done a couple in the F-14, and we did one in the F-18 when it released. But again, like I say, I'm quite a real world procedures type guy, and I know nothing about military aviation. Despite my cousin being in the RAF. when am I flying from Oslo to Bergen? I'm not sure. I only chose to do this flight today because there is an event on here. So maybe I'll try and either line it up with a VATSIM event, or I'll just do it soon. I really love flying in Norway. So, I mean, any excuse, really. Red Hoppy, hello. Good afternoon. Hope you're doing well. Welcome to the chat. Hope you're doing well. Those cars are going up and down the side of the building. Yeah, I noticed that. I'm not sure why that is, to be honest with you. I think it's probably to do with the fact that... oh, no, maybe not. I was going to say it's a car park, isn't it? So maybe there's a road that sort of that is defined in the sim that runs through there. But no, it's clearly not a car park. It's obviously an office building of some description or something. And yeah, I have absolutely no idea why the cars are going up and down the side of the building. Definitely a bug. Look at this, though. I haven't been down here before, I don't think. Oh, look at that. There's even a train. Brilliant. I haven't actually checked out down here before, I don't think, in this airport. Few cars down there. They've got plenty of people here on VATSIM. Love to see it. I'm not sure what that big one's matched as. That's probably an A340, isn't it? Anyways, guys. You guys are probably tired of my random tangents by now. So let's get things set up then. So first of all, I'm just going to grab the ATIS real quick. Now, we don't have ACARs, obviously, in this aircraft. So I'm just going to use V-Pilot to grab the ATIS. I could tune it, but it's pretty unreliable. So we've got information mic. Departure runway is 28, which is actually good. Actually, no, it's not. I don't think I planned for 28, actually. Planned for 34. So we'll have to we'll expect to receive a different departure route, but shouldn't be an issue. Right. QNH is 1031. So let's get that set. Now, I've not flown the CRJ properly in a while, so I don't know if anything's broken at the moment. Right, so that's 1031 set. I'm just going to press B on the keyboard as well and make sure it actually matches what's in the sim, which it does. So that is good. Okay. All right, so let's crack on anyway with some flows and just make sure everything is set up correctly. Make sure the last crew left this aircraft in a proper state. So let's check out overhead to begin with. So we're on battery power. The battery master is on and we're on AC power from the ground power units. Guard, all these switches are guarded. All the lights are out. Everything, it looks good there. All generators are in auto position. We're not going to do all the tests today because, like I say, we're sort of simulating a turnaround here, which the previous crew would have already done the tests. Excuse me. So I don't think the next crew would necessarily do them. Or we could just assume we're the same crew. We're the same crew. And we're doing a turnaround. So I'm not going to do all the tests, but let's do the normal flows anyway. So boost pumps are off now. That's fine. Bleed air normal. Isolation valve. We'll flick that open for once we get underway in case we need it. Probably won't. Bleed valves are auto and bleed source is both engines. APU is off. Ignition is all off. Continuous light is off as well. Hydraulics are all off at the moment. ELT is armed. Cabin pressure is in hold full. Actually, this should be over here like this. So manual rate is in full decrease. These lights are out. And everything is looking good there. We'll set our landing elevation for in case we need to return to the airfield here. So 1,500 we need to set. I'm just going to pop this screen out. You guys won't be able to see that, but at least I can see we're setting the right landing elevation. So I'm going to set that to 1,500 for Zurich. So you can see that is set here in blue. 1,500. Okay, and air conditioning is all packs are showing a fault light because we're not taking on any air at the moment. That's fine. Recirculation fan, we'll put that in the on position for when we do power on. Everything else is looking good there. We'll turn the cockpit temperature down just a touch here. We'll turn the windshield heat to low and we'll put the standby compass light on. I usually just turn that on because why not. Seatbelt signs off and the no smoking sign is in auto. Emergency lights are armed, which reminds me we shall go ahead and we'll actually load the aircraft up as well. So our zero fuel weight for today is going to be 27825 and the fuel we require for the trip is going to be 4959 on the fuel. So let's go ahead and we'll set the payload initially. Obviously, we've not got enough fuel here, so we're going to go and come to the refueling panel. We'll turn that on and we just need a little bit more fuel here. That should do it. So we'll start the refueling process and the fuel now is going up in the two wing tanks, as you can see coming up here as well. So that's loading. We'll come now 2. Don't need to do anything else on that whilst it's refueling. All right. Coming to the autopilot panel. I never know the name of this in the CRJ. Boeing and Airbus aircraft have a good name for this. I can't remember what it is in the CRJ. It's called the auto flight panel or something like that. Anyway, flight directors, we can turn them on. And then coming down here, we'll go to pausing it. We'll grab our GPS position and drop that in there, even though the IRS is already aligned, you can see. And we'll start plugging a few things in here. So we're going to go from Lima Sierra Zulu Hotel, which is Zurich, and we're going to go to Charlie Hotel Zulu. No, we're not. We are going to Echo Kilo Charlie Hotel. Almost at it, right? Ground distance is 513. 513 is checked on my flight plan. Isn't there a rumor Microsoft is reviving the Microsoft Combat Simulator? I have absolutely no idea, to be honest with you, F14 man. It's, no idea. I mean, they might do, you know, it's, if it's something they've done before for Microsoft Flight Simulator, I mean, the Reno Air Racers was sort of based on an old expansion they did. You must have, like, an Alienware computer. Those graphics are very amazing. I mean, to be honest, I was even just saying just in the stream earlier on that I've actually turned down my graphics settings today. But if you want to know my PC specifications, if you look in the description of the video, you can find my specs there. But I do have a relatively decent computer, I would say. I've got a 3080 in there and a 5600X processor. It does the job, let's say. But it's one I built myself. It's not an Alienware or anything like that. F14 man says, so I play Flight Simulator on Xbox, and when I fly with my friend, his aircraft shows up as something totally different than what he's in. Do you know how to fix that? Yeah, so it depends, really. It depends what you've got installed, and it depends what he's got installed. If he's flying a plane that you don't have installed, then it won't show up properly for you. The whole system is not entirely perfect. I've seen it happen where even people who have the same aircraft installed as me, it sometimes doesn't show up. So it's a little bit glitchy at the moment, but that's usually the main thing. Didn't know you could pop screens out. How do you do that? Use the right alt key on your keyboard. Andy Ivy asks, it's called the MCP, isn't it? That's a Boeing term, I believe, MCP. So it's referred to as the MCP in the Boeing, but I believe in a CRJ, obviously it's Bombardier, so they have a different name for it. I can't remember what it's called off the top of my head. I have read it in the manual, but yeah, I don't think it's a... I think I'll get over it if I can't remember it. the alternate is going to be Frankfurt. It's not going to be Frankfurt, it's going to be Hamburg. Originating runway is going to be, it said on the ATIS, runway 28, sorry, there isn't a 24 here. So runway 28, and that should do it for this page. So we'll execute and we'll go ahead and start plugging stuff in. I'm just going to come down here and turn this lighting up a bit as well. All right, so runway 28, we don't actually know what departure we're going to fly yet. So I'm going to leave that blank and we'll go straight to the en route flight plan. So our initial waypoint is Degez. So it's obviously going to be a departure that... ends at Degez, but we just don't know which one it is just yet. Then we're going to take the airway Zulu 1, and that's going to go to Etago. Then from Etago, we're going to go direct to Tikni. That was the wrong button. And then we're going to take the airway November 476. I'll get my numbers and letters in the right order at some point today, I promise. And that's going to go to Mag. Then we're going to go direct to Norbury. Then we're going to go Mike 726 to Rossock. And then from Rossock, we're going to go Quebec 296. And that's to Monarch. Great stuff. And that takes us on to our arrival into Copenhagen. So we're expecting 2-2 right. That could change, but we'll put in 2-2 right for now. And the arrival we can expect is the Monarch 2 Charlie. And we'll just leave it on vectors, because that's usually what happens at Copenhagen. All right, so that's that done. What I'll do next is we shall... Fuel's finished loading, so we'll go ahead and just turn that off and turn that off. We'll come back down here and just init fuel from aircraft. So that's going to bring in the fuel that we've just loaded into our performance calculations here. We'll go set all for our takeoff speeds, and we'll copy our init data to the FMS. So we'll come back to flight plan, then perf init. And the weights are all there already. All we need to do is just stick in our light plan. Our cruising flight level, which is 370, and then our alternate cruising flight level, which is 280. Zero fuel weight, 27825. That's all in. Great stuff. Fuel 4983. Yep, that's perfect. Next page. We're just going to put in our average wing component in here, which is going to be a -23 into here. And taxi fuel, we're allowing 227 on the flight plan. Because it's quite busy here, I'm going to allow a bit more. Let's go 327. That might still not be enough, but we'll put that in there as well. Estimated time of departure is going to be 19:30 Zulu time. Although that's not going to match up with the sim, is it really? We're using daytime lights because, you know why. I've explained it many times before, but let's see if we can at least match up the minutes with the real world Zulu time. So then at least it just helps a little bit. Okay, that only seems to move in larger increments. So, oh, there we go. That's more. Oh my God, I just had it. There we go. Okay. Wait, what? Did that just change on its own? Okay. That's pretty much bang on. Okay, so we'll put in 1930, although we might be a bit later than that, but let's just do that anyway. So that's all in and executed. We'll go to the VNAV page. Transition altitude is 7,000, and we'll cover that again once we get to the briefing. Right, so that's pretty much everything in there. What I'm going to do is just... I'm going to speak to the controller and get our clearance. So, oh my God, every position is staffed. That's amazing. Fantastic. All right, well, let's speak to the delivery controller then and get our clearance. So 121.925.
Lufthansa 1330 confirm squawk.
We'll go ahead and turn the stab and MAC trim on as well, and the yaw damper. I'm just going to wait until I can actually hear what's going on here.
Alexander 1330, thank you. Monitor apron 121.75, bye bye.
Good evening, this is EasyJet 314 looking for a clearance to Berlin.
121.75. Alexander 1330.
Alexander 1330, just confirm, monitor the frequency, he will call you.
Just gonna wait for a second to speak.
Look
at that, someone recommended, someone mentioned Microsoft Combat Simulator. I remember playing that. It was a separate project. A lot of fun. Same World War II.
EasyJet 314.
Nice. Yeah, I never played that myself, Andy, but yeah, it does sound pretty cool. Kind of like a mini DCS.
To Berlin, please.
EasyJet 314, say your stand.
Bravo 27.
EZ314, thank you. November is current, runway 28, clear to Brandenburg, Degas 3 Whiskey departure, climb to 5,000 feet, squawk 6710.
Okay, so he gave him the 3 Whiskey departure. And that's a different one to mine.
Information, November, clear to Berlin, runway 28 for departure, initial climb 5,000 feet, squawk code 6716, and for the SID, DG's S, 3 Whiskey.
Oh yeah, it was mine. DJ's 3 Whiskey.
DJ's okay. 314, is that correct? Call me for startup.
Roger, thank you so much. DJ's 314.
Zurich delivery, very good evening. City Island 610, stand Charlie 52, CRJ 9, November, QNH 1031, request clearance to Copenhagen.
City Island 610, nice call sign. November is correct, runway 28 cleared to Copenhagen. Degas 3 Whiskey departure, climb to 5,000 feet, your squawk 6701.
And thank you very much. So cleared to Copenhagen, runway 28, Degas 3 Whiskey, initial climb 5,000, squawk 6701, City Island 610.
City Island 610, read back is correct. Call me for startup.
Wilco. All right,
good
great
delivery,
stuff.
Very good evening.
that guy liked my call sign. I'm not sure why he liked my call sign, but he liked it.
A321 at stand Alpha 17 with information.
All right, so we're at 6701.
Scandinavian 602, good evening, boss. You are cleared to Copenhagen, runway 28, Degas 3 Whiskey departure, climb initially 5,000 feet.
Okay, fantastic. So Degas 3 Whiskey was the departure he gave us, which is this one right here. So we're going ahead and execute that.
Runway 28, Degas 3 Whiskey departure.
Let's zoom in here and just make sure this is all in the box correctly.
Scandinavian 602, read back is correct. Call me for startup.
We'll call you for startup, Scandinavian.
Okay, so looking at the departure, it does look a bit weird on the ND there, but I think that is correct. So, taking off initially out to KL02, which is 2 miles from the Cloten VOR. We're then going to take a left turn out to Zulu Hotel 552. Then going to take a left turn back in towards the Cloten VOR, out to Momol, Kolul, 504, 525, and then Degas, and then to the en route portion of the flight plan. And then we've got a discontinuity just after Monarch there, so let's just check that out. So we've got Monarch twice. We'll go Monarch and stick that there.
November on board, requesting IFR clearance to Berlin as filed.
Swiss 2 Echo Niner, good Nordic November is correct. Runway 28 cleared Brandenburg. Degas 3 Whiskey departure, climb to.
Okay, so that looks about fine. Obviously, we should be on vectors at that point, so this tight turn here shouldn't really make a difference. It looks like we've got a one waypoint in there twice, maybe.
Swiss 2 Echo Niner, read back correct. Call me for.
No, we don't. I think it was just the vectors leg there that was making me press it twice to advance. Okay, great stuff. So that is all in then. Let's have a look then, and we'll do a a departure briefing in just a second. I think we're more or less set up, though, here in the flight deck. Let's just do a quick scan of the originating check. I'm just going to read that in my head. I'm not going to read them all out because that's a lot to read out, but I'm pretty sure we've completed that checklist. Okay, yeah, so the originating checks are complete. Initial climb clearance will set here as 5,000 feet.
Swiss 8 Zulu, Bravo, monitor open 1:1.75, are they?
Okay, and then in terms of nav aids, we'll get a couple of nav aids tuned here because we've got... we've got a departure that relies on... Well, it doesn't rely on, but it certainly uses some ground-based nav aids.
Delivery good to know, peak November is correct, runway 28 cleared.
So we're on the Degas 3 Whiskey.
Climb to 5,000 feet.
So you can see here we've got the Cloten VOR, which will be flying inbound on the 231 radial. And then, well, that's actually it. So we'll tune the Cloten VOR, or at least make sure that that is tuned in here and it's not going to auto-tune to something else. So that's going to be 11485. It should already be tuned. It is indeed. So I'll put that to manual. We'll put it on both sides, why not? And then we'll bring up the bearing needle here, so we've got a bit more awareness of where that is. Right.
Delta Sierra Lima, thank you. You can monitor apron 1:1.75. Good day.
All right, I think we are just about there.
Lufthansa William Hotel is fully ready. Lufthansa 1 Lima Hotel, you can monitor apron.
Let's start the APU anyway.
Monitor apron 1275 zone of Lufthansa
William Hotel. APU invite, APU shuttle valve open. I set up a new camera as well where we can actually watch the APU door open here. Oh, we've missed it. Oh, yeah, you can see it's just finishing its animation there. Let's start the APU. We'll go ahead and turn the... they're actually already on in that position. Okay, we'll turn the boost pumps on as well, just so that is on. We'll go ahead and put the hydraulic systems to auto and on. No smoke. Seatbelt signs can come to on as well now because we've got the fuel on board. And we're just waiting for the APU, really. There we go. APU is started up. Okay. Let's see what we've got here. We've still got some doors open, so let's go ahead and close those. So we'll close the forward cargo door, passenger door.
Monitor the frequency, please.
And we are on APU power now, so I'm actually going to disconnect the AC power. We'll disconnect the ground power cart and remove the wheel chocks. Parking brake is set. Okay. Great stuff. City Island 610 is ready for departure.
City Line 610, thank you. Monitor apron 1:1.75. Bye-bye.
1:1.75 for City Island 610. Thank you. Bye-bye. One 21750.
Pod ready, Delta Echo, Express Lima. This 8 Zulu Bravo, push and start approved.
We'll go ahead and turn our transponder on because that's the only way the ground controller will see that we've got the correct squawk code in with the CRJ for whatever reason.
Bye-bye.
View aircraft showing up there on TCAS. We're going to put the TCAS on above as well. So he said monitor the frequency, so I'm not going to say anything. I'm just going to wait for him to contact me.
Lufthansa 3 Romeo Hotel, go ahead. Lufthansa 3 Romeo Hotel, startup approved, 3 post ready for taxi.
Oh, I've just realised, guys, I haven't done the departure briefing with you, have I? My bad, I do apologise. I'll do one as we taxi out, because we'll probably have to wait at the runway for a bit. I'm gonna get some of my other frequencies tuned here, so we'll probably get past to
apron with the orbit. We're still at Kalina at gate.
We'll probably get past to the ground frequency. So we're gonna go next to the ground frequency. This frequency we're on currently is the apron, so we'll probably go to the ground frequency next, which is 1216. And then the tower frequency following that, which we'll put in later on, because this radio you can't seem to use on VATSIM for whatever reason.
Victor, Kilo standby on tower frequency 118.1.
Standby on 118.
Yeah, it still doesn't work, this radio on VATSIM, for whatever reason. All right, so we're just waiting for our startup clearance. What we'll do is we'll get the tug connected, so we're ready to go. Loads of people here now, love it. Dave, welcome to the chat, dude. Hope you're doing well, mate. Good to see you. I'll catch up with the rest of the chat once we are moving a little bit here, guys. Obviously, I don't want to miss his call.
Okay, sir. The bypass pin.
I've set up another camera as well, a tug cam. Where are we? Tug cam. Here we go. Okay, it doesn't...
Parking brakes are set. You may lift.
Doesn't really work for this this model. I must have set it up with a different model. Here we are. Oh wow, that looks interesting inside. Yeah, so tug cam. I set it up using a different tug, I think, but yeah, it's not too bad. Because there's a different tug model that I've got for some airports. So it don't quite work as well with this tug, but nevertheless. I really wish it would actually spawn in the proper tug, because like obviously that tug is way too big for this size of aircraft.
Sierra Lima at holding point, Papa 1, ready for departure.
Delta Sierra Lima, copy, stand by tower 118.1, ciao.
118.1, thanks for those, bye.
Swiss 188, is ready for taxi.
So we're just waiting for that call from the apron controller here.
Taxi holding position Alpha 2 via Inter and Alpha.
Taxi to hold.
So if you put your call sign in on this page right here, it actually shows. Oh no. Wait, what the? Oh, did I miss that? Did I miss that off the init page? Maybe I did.
And Swiss 188.
I did.
Page, make a left onto Juliet, then the right Alpha.
That's why.
Left on Juliet, right on Alpha due to traffic.
There we go. Much better.
Lufthansa 3 Romeo Hotel, we're ready. Taxi.
Hey, Cody. Thank you very much for the sub on YouTube. I'm going to catch up with the chat momentarily, guys. I'm just waiting for a call from this controller.
Great. Holding point Alpha 2 by Alpha, and we'll give way to the A340.
Sun Express.
Swiss 2 Echo 9, push and start approved.
Push and start approved, Swiss 2 Echo 9.
Wow, so many aircraft here at the moment.
And Swiss 8 to the Bravo, ready for taxi.
I'm going to give him like two more minutes to contact me, and then I'm just going to say something, because I've been on the frequency quite a while now, so I would have thought he would have already contacted me. Or maybe not, I don't know. I'll tell you what we can do while we wait is we... could do a departure briefing. Actually, no, I'm not going to do it, because I will...
Yeah, station 4, push and start, then by my frequency, call you in sequence.
Okay, right, so that guy called. He's just been transferred over. If we hear him get his clearance before us, then we know to get in touch. So I'm just going to wait here for a minute.
188, standby tower, 118.1, ciao.
118.1, sure, Orbic, Swiss 188.
Andy Sold, he says he remembers Microsoft Space Simulator. Dude, that sounds really cool. I don't remember that one, though. One time you got Squawk 7001. Yeah, I think I've had definitely a few beginning with 70 before. Roblox channel. Yeah, this is Microsoft Flight Sim. Cody, welcome to the chat. Hope you're doing well. Flight number is the flight number is BCY 610, City Island 610, in other words, and the airline is it's Scandinavian Airlines, operated by CityJet. He said monitor, but I would call him. Yeah, I'm going to just drop my call sign in on the frequency in just a second. Do I have a route? Yes, I do, Mariner. Yeah, yeah. Are you joining along?
Lufthansa 3, Romeo Hotel, standby tower 118.1. See ya.
Standby tower 118.1, Lufthansa 3, Romeo Hotel. Thanks for
that. So the runways on my route are actually wrong, Mariner, but I'll drop the route in anyway for you.
Lufthansa 2014 for crossing, contact tower 118.1.
For crossing tower 118.1, Lufthansa 2014.
Swiss 2 Echo 9, are ready for taxi.
Swiss 2 Echo 9, taxi holding position Alpha 2 via Foxtrot and Alpha.
I'm going to say something now. I'm going to say something.
Via Foxtrot and Alpha, Swiss 2 Echo 9.
Apron, City Island 610. Hello?
Station calling, standby, call in sequence.
Roger, thank you. Alright, great stuff. So he knows we're here. Sort of. Cody, yeah, glad to have you here as well, dude. Glad to have you here as well. Ever heard of Captain Canada? Yeah, I certainly have, dude. I certainly have. Love Captain Canada. Absolute legend. How do you get live ATC? You get live ATC. I'm using VATSIM. An online network called VATSIM. Hey, Ramsey, welcome to the chat, dude. Welcome. Yeah, it's a really nice airport, this one. Do I fly X-Plane 11? Yes, we do X-Plane 11 sometimes, yeah. Yep.
Say 20 meters exactly backwards.
Let's see. It is on the VATSIM network. Yes, I'm on the VATSIM.
Bravo, standby tower 118.1. Bye-bye.
Hey, Ramsey, let's go, dude. Thank you for the 100 stars, mate. Very generous, as always. Thank you. First class ticket coming right up, mate. Coming right up. Sounds busy. Yeah, it's an event here at Zurich.
Yes.
But, yeah, I'm currently waiting for my pushback clearance. Got all these players here. So many. So we've got a couple of Swiss, EasyJet, we've got another Swiss, Lufthansa, Scandinavian.
Stations, standby, we have departure ban 10 minutes, so standby.
Departure ban for 10 minutes, is that what you said? God damn. So that's supposed to be an A340 there, and it's got a plane underneath it. It's like it's giving birth to some kind of diamond aircraft. And then we've got a Swiss, a Lufthansa CRJ. What else have we got? We've got Sun Express. I'm not sure what country they actually originate from. If someone in the chat knows, please do tell me.
Lufthansa 1, Lima Hotel, standby tower 118.1.
We've got Lufthansa here in an A321. Swiss A321. Oh, what's this one? A Sky. Never heard of that one before.
I'm not moving. I do have it before.
Oh, look at this big boy. Swiss 777.
Yeah, actually, you are still on my main taxiway, so that's the issue with the fall scenery. In your scenery, do you have a northern terminal called Echo Terminal?
Hold on for a second, please.
Look at this queue.
Hold on for a minute, I'll get back to you.
This is a queue. Sun Express. Oh, it's Turkish German. Thank you.
118.1, be advised, you have departure ban, expect 10 minutes more than usual.
Roger that, 118.1, perfect, second, and I thank you, Robert.
Yeah, he did say there was a takeoff ban. Oh. We're going to have to wait, guys.
Fracture 266 with you on Phuket.
We'll just watch the traffic whilst we wait.
Taxi,
what have we got at this, this terminal over here? Oh, that's just a blank white.
Any chance could we get Delta 10 because we're actually a biz jet?
Fraction 266, Delta 10, you can expect that. Taxi to be a full short runway 28.
Alright, guys, so we're just going to have to chill here for a minute. He's not going to give us our pushback clearance until their departure ban's over, so we're just going to have to chill for a minute.
Delta 11.
Apron, Scandinavian 602 with a question.
Tell you what I'm going to do. I'm just going to back off a little bit so it's not so loud.
Scandinavian 602, go ahead.
Scandinavian 602, we would just like to hear an ETA on the push and whether we should maybe switch off the APU and go back to external power.
Scandinavian 602, you are number 2 in sequence for push, however, you have to expect about another, let's say, 12 minutes.
Roger that. We'll go back to external power for about 8 to 10 minutes then. Scandinavian 602, thank you.
12 minutes!
I'll advise you when
you're pushing. Meh!
And,
that's painful.
Airline 001, is there any chance you can just move forward by about 20 meters? Then you would be perfectly positioned.
That's painful. Right, let's read the chat because we're not going anywhere anytime soon. Little cheeky window view here. You can watch those aircraft over there.
Do you know what number am I in the sequence?
Right then, so...
DC-314, you're number 3 in sequence.
Do I ever play with a VR headset? I do not know. I don't own one, but I would like one. I would like one, but it's just not really in my budget at the moment. Disconnect and take off again. That's some next level strategy right there.
Welcome back, taxi 3-2, yeah.
But no, I won't be doing that. I'm just going to wait. I actually like waiting. It's quite immersive. Yahya, welcome to the chat.
Seems like you missed,
hope you're doing well. Welcome.
Bravo now. Oh, sorry, we said Kilo. My mistake.
No, Ramsey, yes, it is Microsoft Flight Simulator. Yeah.
Roger, Bravo then.
Ah, Cody, you've been watching Captain Canada today. Awesome. I think he streamed Microsoft Flight Simulator as well, didn't he? He streamed, what was it? It was a Turkish Airlines, I think, in the A320. Is this Microsoft Flight Simulator? And if so, you're using that really... Yes, I am. Yeah, I'm using the AIG traffic, Ramsey. Yeah. Wayne, welcome to the chat, dude. Oi, oi. Hope you're doing well, mate. Good to see you.
Copy that, Oscar Tango Hotel, taxi J, sector that north. What was that again? Sorry, my mistake.
Lake Tuma, welcome to the chat. Hope you're doing well. Dream Vega asks, why is there a ban? Now, there's probably a ban for multiple reasons that I'm not aware of. But it's probably because there's an event on here at Zurich today. And the center controllers have probably said, we can't handle any more traffic at the moment. So you're going to have to stop releasing aircraft for a while. until the airspace clears up a bit. I imagine that's probably what it's to do with, something like that. Obviously, it happens quite a lot in real life as well. It's, you know, one of the main reasons why you'll end up with a delay on your air on your aircraft. Yahir, I am doing very well, thank you. Yeah, how are you doing?
I'm holding short on Juliet.
Yeah, 12 minutes he said, wasn't it? FCAM. He did say to that other aircraft, though, he did say that they were second in the queue. So I think that puts me first. I think I must be first, surely. Thomas Rask, welcome to the chat, dude. I hope you're doing well, mate. You've not missed a lot yet. No, we're just waiting for a pushback clearance, and there's a bit of a delay at the moment. You guys are ready for me to push back? I'm ready to push back, dude. I'm sat here with the APU firing away. Wait a minute. There it is. For some reason, the APU doesn't have a heat blur. I think that must be a bug, but the APU is on, and, you know, we're here making loads of noise. We've got our hydraulics on and everything. You know? You're not supposed to have your APU on for an extended period of time at Zurich, but because I'm expecting my clearance any second now, I'm just going to wait a bit longer. I'm sorry, I'm just going to leave it on. Oh, look at this. What is that? Oh, it's an A321. I thought it was much bigger than what it was.
This is 383 for crossing. Contact tower 118.1. See you soon.
I'm crossing 118.1.
Yeah, Ramsey, grab it, dude. I've done a full I did a full video on my YouTube channel, a full tutorial on how to install it if you want to check it out. James, welcome to the chat, dude. Hope you're doing well. Welcome, welcome, welcome. They'll be controlling, they'll be flow controlling due to the event. Yeah, I thought that might be the case. It's
To make uniform channel, yeah. Do you prefer the sector 4?
Sector 4.
Oh, that's an Istanbul airline, Batuhan. Thank you, dude. Thank you.
Yeah, and see, that's exactly why you should call me prior to taxiing and not just taxi around without contacting me. Let me
know
the position and let me know once you know where you
are. Oh, no. Someone got told off. So the AIG makes airplanes correct with what people are using. Yeah, basically, yeah. On VATSIM it does, yeah. Oh shit, Ramsey, I'm missing all your stars here. Dude, thank you so much. 200 stars in total for Ramsey. 300 stars in total. Thank you so much. Very generous as always, dude. Very generous. Thank you so much. Dude, Cody, thank you so much. Legend, thank you. Time for a wee. Yeah, Dave, I think now is the time, if any. Bruno, thank you for the clearance, dude. Thank you.
Thank God I'm not departed. Yeah. Done my free flight to this thing for today.
Yeah, here, the transit guy. No, I'm not. I'm the ground dude. I think I missed something there, haven't I?
And again, Zurich Abrams, Swiss 50 holding short, Alpha.
Swiss 383, well.
Wait, Yahya, are you this controller I'm listening to?
Caution, there's some default scenery pilot on inner, but you can pass by them.
Mariner, I'm on stand, Alpha 5-2. I think it shows as Charlie 5-2 on the scenery, though.
Yep, bye. That was two stations. The other station calling.
Guys, you'll have to let me know what the quality's like as well, because I've upped the bitrate loads as well, so it should be pretty good on YouTube now. I can't believe we've been waiting this long, to be honest. Thank you very much, James, dude. I'm glad you're enjoying it, even though we're just sat here waiting. Having to listen with the volume off, am I BCY610? I am indeed, yes. I am indeed from above. Although you wouldn't have heard me if you've got the sound off, will you? So I'm just going to do this. I'm just going to do this. Correct. Oh, you're the guy who's standing on the ground. Got you, dude. what are we waiting for? We're waiting for a pushback clearance. As you can see, it's very busy here at Zurich at the moment on VATSIM. You can see we've already got 1, 2, 3 aircraft queuing to line up for the runway here. I'm not sure why they don't use another runway as well. Or do they all cross here? These two cross, don't they? But then they've got this one, which I imagine they're using for arrivals.
Sorry, Apron. Very good evening. Air 788 6 Heavy, located Hotel 1.
Yeah, at the moment they've got a departure ban for a few more minutes, so we're just going to have to wait for our clearance, unfortunately. Leon, good evening, sir. Hope you're doing well, mate. Good to see you. We are still on the ground. Indeed, yep. Yeah. Just waiting for a pushback clearance. We're probably absolutely rinsing fuel in the APU. Jonathan, good evening, sir. Hope you're doing well. Welcome, welcome. Is this Ryanair delayed? It's not, no, it's not. Wow, all those airplanes are real people. Yes, all of these are all real people on the VATSIM network. I think this is just a few of them as well. There's one more over there. CRJ, Lufthansa. And then, yeah, that is it. There's no more behind us. And there's one down there. And then there's us. But yeah, all real people here. Everybody's just waiting at the moment, though, because there's a departure ban for Zurich temporarily. Bruno, destination is Copenhagen.
City Island 6108.
City Island 610, ready to copy.
City Island 610, reclearance, confirm ready to copy.
Ready to copy, City Island 610.
Greetings from UAE 160 on VATSIM.
Cleared runway 32 Degas through 5 Lima departure, City Island 610.
City Island 610, is that correct?
Okay, cool. So we'll just get our FMS adjusted. We've been given a different runway and a different departure because of all the traffic here. So we're just going to get that plugged in. So runway 32. Degas 5 Lima departure.
Degas 5 Lima out of runway 32 instead.
All right, let's just check that that is all okay. I'm just going to cross check that against the chart here. Let me just turn the music down again. So they're changing runways by the looks of things. And we are on the 5 Lima departure. Okay, so taking off runway 32, then a left turn, then another left turn, then another left turn, back in towards the airport. And then this is completely RNAV, this departure. So I'm actually going to go ahead and put the radios back to auto, because that's not going to make too much of a difference here. All right, cool. So we are ready to go then. How much fuel have we got? 4925. What do we need to take off?
Four seven three two.
So we've still got enough to go.
Welcome back, taxi stand Alpha 570 at Juliet and Inner.
Taxi to stand Alpha 75 at Juliet, Lufthansa 979.
Lufthansa 979, stand Alpha 57.
Holy crap! And Inner. We have 71 people watching on YouTube. No way.
Alpha 57 via Inner Lufthansa
979. Dude, guys, welcome! That's wild. Hope we're all doing well. Welcome, welcome. I didn't realize there's so many people.
5.
Everybody's just sat here waiting for me to do something. Well, if you're enjoying the stream so far anyway, guys, do hit the thumbs up button. Really, really does help out the channel. So we'd appreciate that if you're enjoying the content. But welcome, welcome. If it's your first time here, I'm Bobby Fuzzy. We try and do things sort of realistically here on the channel. And we try and simulate a lot of different kinds of airliner flights. And we have a lot of fun, don't we, chat? Or at least we try to.
Ground Swiss 9077. Good evening.
Oh, you're here too, as Matt. Oh, I thought you'd spawned in, but you're in the chat. Awesome. I'm actually really warm now.
Juliet, hold short 28, 9077.
City Island 610 is ready for departure.
City Island 610, are you sure you're still on your stand?
Correction, we're ready for push and start. City Island 610.
Yeah, City Island 610, we're handling a departure band, so you have to stay for another few minutes, but stand by, I'll call you about 2 to 4 minutes.
Sure, no problem. Thanks for the update, City Island 610. All right, so still waiting, guys, as you guys just heard.
Yeah, when I was taxiing, someone did a runway incursion. I squished the king air.
Oh no, a runway incursion. What's going on? Alright, so we've got a few minutes anyway, guys, so let's go ahead then, and we might as well do a departure briefing, because we have got a bit of time. So, let's bring up our charts, and we'll have a look. Okay, so this is our routing today, basically straight north out of Switzerland, over Germany, and then down over...
City Island 610, push and start approved, face north.
Push and start approved, face north, City Island 610. Okay, guys, we'll come back to that. We'll come back to that. We've got our pushback clearance finally. Let's get the camera on. So, pushing back facing north, so that is a turn to the left.
Cockpit to ground. We are cleared for start and push.
Scandinavian
parking brake set.
Push and start approved, face east.
Okay, cleared for push and start.
Approved, face east.
Please release parking brake.
Parking brake is released.
Parking brakes are released.
Commencing pushback.
You can 314, push and start approved.
It will start in the sequence.
Push and start approved.
Let's do our tug cam. Actually, wait, is that an aircraft? Okay, they're not moving. Okay, that's fine. Let's turn the beacon light on as well, and we'll go for the right engine starts. Can't do the tug cam just yet. I need to get this engine started. We've got a bit of distance to go anyway. So N2's coming up. Wait for 20%, and we'll bring in the fuel flow. There we go. Fuel flow. For the right engine, right auto ignition, right fuel pump on. That was on anyway. There we go.
April, hello, Golf Charlie, Golf 5-3 at General Aviation Area, Cessna Vancouver.
Golf Charlie, Golf 5-3, April, Grietzi, go ahead.
Requesting taxi, sir. For
there we go, engine light off.
Golf Charlie Echo 5-3, what is your intended outbound route after departure?
We have a flight from Zurich.
This tug needs to slow the hell down.
We have Oscar Chinich 1032.
Okay, so that is a good engine start there.
Golf Charlie Echo 5-3.
Looks like it's stabilized.
Let's copy the information uniform.
Let's go for a left engine start.
Is correct. Stand by, I'll coordinate with tower for your departure runway.
Roger, information uniform, Golf Charlie Echo 5-3.
We'll just get him to give us a little bit of a twist around, so we're pointing in the right direction at least.
You have information uniform on General Aviation Lake West, taxi on route 32.
Delta Charlie Foxtrot, were you cleared for startup for by delivery?
Roger that.
That was a question. Were you cleared for startup by delivery?
We'll hold it there. Set the parking brake. Start the fuel flow for engine 1. Parking brake is set. Parking brake on. Okay.
Startup is complete.
6.5 on the trim.
Roger. Delivery tells me that he did not give you startup approval, so for now, shut down the engine. Expect about 10 more minutes.
Oh, tell the Charlie Fox that I misunderstood that. Okay, shut down.
No worries.
EasyJet 314 is ready for taxi.
Right, so we didn't do the before start checklist because I was so enamored by everything else that was going on, so we're just gonna skip forward and assume we've done all that stuff, which to be fair we have done it anyway. Everything is all done anyway, so that's all completed. What's the temperature looking like here? 1 degree. Okay, so we're gonna need some anti-ice, so we'll get the anti-ice set, which I forget where it is on here. Actually, it's right here. Cowl anti-ice. We'll turn the probes on now. The engines are started. We'll also do nothing else. Yes, we've done everything. We'll turn the APU off here as well. So APU start and then APU power. We should be able to see the APU door close here as well. If you look here, you can actually see the APU door closing, which is very cool.
05 via Juliet and inner Swiss 977.
Right. Okay, so after start checklist, generators are auto electrics.
Apron, Swiss 29 on Victor, ready for push and start.
Yeah,
electrics are checked. Bleed valves are auto, packs are on, APU is off, anti-ice is on, nose wheel steering. We can go ahead and arm that as well. So after start checklist is complete. We'll do the taxi checklist now. So slats and flaps, we'll set the flaps to 8. Just make sure that comes out all the way. Flaps 8 is set. Flight controls, we'll do a flight controls check now. Right here. So full left, full right, full up, and full down on the elevator. Full left on the rudder, and full right, and back to neutral. Flight controls are checked. Trim is green and checked. Thrust thrusters, I'll arm those. Flight instruments are checked and brake temperature is checked. Taxi checklist is complete. So let's just have a look at the taxi chart real quick and just make sure we know where we're going. So it's probably going to be Mike Foxtrot. It's probably going to be Mike Foxtrot, then maybe Inner A. And then down. We're not doing runway 28 now. We're doing runway 34, aren't we? So it's probably then going to be a bit different to that. So it might just be a case of, he said pushback facing north. So it'll probably be Mike and then Echo. Echo 9, runway 34.
Lufthansa 1457, push and start approved. Yeah.
Oh, that's runway. Oh my god. this is runway 34. We're doing runway 32, god damn it. Right, runway 34. Sorry, 3-2, all the way up here. Okay, it's going to be a long taxi then. Let's see what he says. City Island 610, ready for taxi.
City Island 610, taxi hall, correction, taxi. Via Mike Foxtrot and Alpha Hotchurch runway 28 on Kilo.
Taxi Mike Foxtrot, Alpha Hotchurch runway 28 on Kilo, City Island 610.
EC314 next left, standby tower.
Okay, let's get this nose light on for the taxi.
Holding short 28 for the 314.
Scandinavian 602 for now, hold short of Alpha.
Let's go. Parking brake is released. We should be able to just roll forwards on idle power with the anti-ice on.
Standby tower 118.1, bye bye.
We'll monitor your.
Takeoff config is okay there. As you can see, rolling on idle power here, no problems at all. So we're taxiing Mike, which we're on currently. Taxiing Mike.
Alpine 3-1 Charlie.
Then Foxtrot. All the way up on Foxtrot. That's the wrong chart. Up on Foxtrot. And then right onto Alpha. Oh, actually, no. Oh, no, that's wrong. Let me just slow myself down here so I can actually review the charts. I'm going to do it on my other screen and I'll show you guys in a sec because I need to see where I'm going here.
Midnight 1-2 for crossing. Standby tower, correction, contact tower 118.1. See you.
Okay, so he said Mike, then Foxtrot, hold short of runway 28 at Kilo. Okay, got it. Right. So, I'm going to take this turn and then I'll show you guys where we're going. Look how low down we look compared to those aircraft there.
Yeah, Swiss 405, standby in sequence, call you when I'm ready.
Copy.
Okay, so you can see on the ground there, F for Foxtrot to the right. So we're going to follow it to the right. And then once we get straightened up here, I can hopefully tell you guys what we're doing. Right, here we go. Guys, if you're talking in the chat as well, I will catch up with the chat. But as you can see here, this is quite a handful at the moment. Right, so we are on mic. We've just come on to Foxtrot here. We're about here where this three is. We're going to continue on up Foxtrot. And then we're going to come out on the bottom of this next chart, just down here. Foxtrot all the way up. We're going to take a right onto Alpha. And then we are going to come along here. And then we're going to take left here and hold short at here. This is Kilo. And we're going to hold short here of runway 28 until we are cleared to cross.
Delta Charlie Fox, no taxi holding position. Papa 1, report ready.
All right. So we'll do the departure briefing as well whilst we're here. So I can do that on my separate monitor whilst I am taxiing. So I've briefed you guys on the taxi already. We make sure we're still going the right way, though. So we're currently taxiing up here on Foxtrot.
Still didn't get the catch up on top tower.
We're going to take a right at the top onto Alpha and then hold short at Kilo right here. You can see this is a hotspot here with the magenta ring. That's a hotspot, HS2. So we've got hotspot 2, aircraft taxiing on Echo, Foxtrot, Juliet or Kilo, behave of runway ahead. That's what it's telling us basically. Then we can probably expect further clearance to go across the runway via Kilo, and then Hotel 3 is probably going to be where we'll get sent from that point. So we're taking off runway 32. We've got a bit of a last minute change there. We're going to take off runway 32, initially flying on 327 track up to Zulu Hotel 580. Minimum altitude there is 3,500 feet. And we're going to take a left turn. So that's quite a steep climb gradient there.
Golf Charlie Echo 5. Expect runway 28 for departure when ready.
And then we're going to take a left turn 241 degrees towards Zulu Hotel 569, then another left turn to intercept Zulu Hotel 568, and then head outbound at 087 speed, maximum 210 knots for this part of the procedure, so we'll have to bear that in mind. Minimum altitude here 5,000 feet, so we can expect further clearance. See, our initial clearance down here is 5,000. So we can expect further clearance to a higher altitude before this turn, basically. Then we're going to continue out towards Momol, Kollul, and then out to Deges. So the rest of the procedure is pretty straightforward. It's just this speed restriction we need to pay attention to on the way out.
So I got the new one for you, taxi stand Delta 01 via Juliet Inner Echo Mike.
Okay, so we are here now on Alpha, just taking a right turn, and Kilo should be coming up
Alpha 01,
on our left somewhere.
Midnight 1-2, correct, accept the stand, Delta 01.
What's this guy doing?
Delta 01, Roger,
Midnight
1-2.
Delta Charlie Foxtrot, Papa 1.
Delta Charlie Foxtrot, I may have made actually standby short. Yeah, Delta Charlie Fox.
Okay, he's moving now.
You can now contact tower 118.1.
Not sure why.
118.1, bye bye.
I don't know, maybe he had the wrong scenery. So this is Juliet here. We need to go to the next one, I believe, which is Kilo. So Juliet here, and then Kilo is the next one along. The colleague over there, Scandinavian 3, is that a 19 or a 20? Might be a 20. All right, so we're looking out for Juliet here. I can just about make out the J on that sign there to the left.
Lufthansa 1457, hold short of Kilo.
Push for Kilo.
And actually, Lufthansa 1457, you just passed.
Guys, I will catch up with the chat once we're underway here. What in the world? Nice.
City Island 610, you are number one in the sequence, so you can take off.
Roger, thank you, City Island 610.
On City Island 610 for you too, hold short of Kilo, stand by tower 118.1, bye bye.
Hold short in Kilo, 118.1, City Island 610. Okay.
Golf Charlie Echo 5, please stand by tower 118.1, bye bye.
118.1, thanks for the service, Golf Charlie Echo 5.
Trying to make sure I don't miss my turn here. All these aircraft, this is chaos, man. What was that other aircraft doing?
Short on it.
Emirates 902, standby, correction for crossing, contact tower 118.1.
Oh, is that the Emirates?
Thank you, Emirates 902.
It's behind us.
Go
ahead, that's the 1031, good number.
Okay, parking brake is set. Let's go to tower. The Lufthansa was on VATSIM as well, Earth from above.
Traffic on short, final in sight.
Tower Emirates 902 on Juliet, looking to cross runway 28.
Hotel India Bravo, behind the traffic on short, final land, heliport west on discretion, wind variable.
Oh yes, look at that, Emirates 777.
Land heliport west on discretion, Hotel India Bravo, danke.
Hotel Papa X-ray. Cross airfield approved, next report Whiskey 2, traffic is helicopter landing, heliport west.
Whee, love it. City Island 610, holding short 28 a kilo.
Emirates 6902 on Juliet, cross runway 28, after crossing contact apron 121.75.
Cross to it on Juliet and contact you, Panama 902.
And easy 314 airport.
Easy 314, go ahead.
Bit close.
Who do I contact for departure on airport?
Sorry about that, contact arrival 131.130.550. Alpine 31 Charlie Alpha, wind variable 6 knots, runway 32 clear for takeoff.
Can take off 32 Alpine 31 Charlie Alpha.
Midnight 7, make it.
Midnight 7, contact April 111.750.
111.750, midnight 7.
City Ireland 610 on Kilo, cross runway 28, no delay, please.
Cross runway 28 kilo, City Island 610, no delay. All right, let's go. Let's get the strobe lights on. We're crossing an active runway. Give it a bit of power just to get out of this guy's way because he wants us to clearly move. We haven't got anyone waiting to take off though, so let's just hurry on anyway. This guy, this Emirates must have wrong scenery. Probably the same as that other one that was blocking the taxiway.
Tower is kind of around 602. Can we taxi the whole short line of the runway?
Scandinavian 062, stand by short, call you back.
Look at the hill on the runway there. Love it.
Lufthansa 1457.
Turn the strobes off. Okay, so before takeoff checklist, lights and strobes, we'll turn them on as we come in. Crossflow to manual. Flight attendants are advised TCAS is set and the transponder is set. Terrain radar display doesn't work in this aircraft, and CAS is checked and okay. Before takeoff checklist is complete, we'll go ahead and box those white items there. Okay, so he just instructed us to cross the runway, so I'm just going to come all the way through here and just hold here.
Zurich arrival 130.55.
10455 for Apache 1 Charlie Alpha, protect the bike.
Zurich Tower, good evening, Swiss 1069 with you, Alice Switch.
Swiss 1069, Zurich Tower, low wind variable 6 knots, runway 2 is clear to land, after landing, vacate left, runway 34 available for.
So we're currently here on Kilo. We could probably carry on going, to be fair, all the way to Hotel 3, I imagine. I'm just going to keep on going, because this controller's really busy, so I don't want to... I don't want to unnecessarily call him. Guys, I'll catch up with the chat once we get underway here. As you can hear, it's very busy.
Tower, to
as you can see, we've got TA only above. We can actually go ahead and turn the weather radar on, even though it's not going to show us anything.
You're on Kilo holding short on way to wait, but you should. He gave you instructions to hold short on Alpha on Kilo.
Holy crap, how many people are watching right now? This is wild! Guys, welcome! Welcome! Welcome to the stream.
Yeah.
Listen, the 1457, do you want us to reverse?
Guys, I will catch up with the chat once we get underway here.
57, no, that's not necessary.
Hotel 3? So we're going to hold here.
Wait, after crossing, continue on Kilo, holding point, Hotel 3.
Hello, Hotel 3,
City Island 610, holding at Hotel 3.
Well established, ILS 28.
Hotel Bravo, Juliet Tango, Zulu, Zurich Tower, hello.
I blocked someone there, I think.
Traffic is vacating, wind variable 6 knots, runway 28, clear to land.
Traffic vacating, runway 28, clear to land, Hotel.
Someone incoming for 28.
Hotel Tango Zulu, after landing, vacate left runway 34 available for taxi.
Roger, vacate left runway 34 available, Hotel Tango Zulu.
Delta Charlie Foxtrot, we have stern traffic on short final inside.
Delta Charlie Foxtrot, traffic inside.
Delta Charlie Foxtrot behind the department, behind the landing traffic on short final. On Papa 1 cross.
Getting paid for playing Fight Sim. Nobody's paying me anything, dude.
Traffic on runway 28, cross runway 28.
I receive very kind tips occasionally from you very generous people.
0 wind variable 6 knots, runway 32 clear for takeoff.
32 clear for takeoff, City Island 610.
Hotel Papa.
Okay, we're clear for takeoff. Beautiful. Let's get the landing lights on and the taxi light as we've got our clearance. We'll get the strobe light on as well. We've done our before takeoff checklist. Let's activate the takeoff mode. Okay, we are ready to go.
145 behind the landing traffic. Cross runway 28 behind.
Check the approach sector, which is very difficult to see from this seat, but yeah, all looking clear. We've got another aircraft landing there. We're not going to expect anyone really to be landing here, are we? And we're clear for takeoff, so we're just going to go for an immediate rolling start. Let's go ahead and start the chrono here.
1069 on Lima, cross runway 28 after crossing, contact apron 11.750.
Okay. Rolls up to about 50%.
Confirm runway 34.
Looking stabilized and up to Toga. We're off, guys, finally.
Hotel Papa X-ray frequency change up.
80 knots. Great runway textures on this runway. It's almost an illusion. It makes the runway look shorter than it actually is. V1 and rotate.
After landing, vacate left.
Positive rates. Gear up.
Information Piper 28 is crossing the airfield for to the southwest.
Bit of trim up there. And we'll go for nav mode.
1-6 is available for this before Foxtrot.
Hello, Charlie Foxtrot, runway 28 located.
And 1,000 feet above ground level. Let's go back to the climb detents and lower the nose just a touch.
Continue on Bravo Hotel to Link Point Hotel 3. Continue via Bravo Hotel to Hotel 3.
Okay, I'm going to get the AP straight in.
610, contact arrival 130.
And we'll start our XLOs. Say again for City Island 610.
130.550.
135.550, City Island 610.
Hotel Tango Zulu, contact Apron 11.750, bye-bye.
Apron 11.75, Hotel Tango Zulu, shut up.
Please, false mercy, Lufthansa 145.
Okay, I'm going to come back on the throttles here so we don't break that speed limit that we've got on the departure here. Okay, we've got alt cap FMS 1, so we're looking good on the automation. We've got an aircraft right above us here. 135.550. Oh, it was 225, not 550. Okay, we're looking fine.
375 or 15325, call sign only immediate.
Beautiful. We've still got flaps one out at the moment, guys, because we're still flying at a low speed.
031, descent flight level 100.
Descent flight level 100, 021.
City Island 610, good afternoon, Zurich radar. We're at level at 5,000 feet on the Degas 5 Lima.
Yeah, City Island 610, contact departure 130.55.
Apologies, 135.55, City Island 610.
13.
Oh, put the wrong frequency in.
Flight 7501, turn left heading 09.
And I changed my frequency before I heard him correct me.
Easy 729, turn right heading 090.
Right heading 090 is
7. Easy 729, contact final 125325, call down on nearby.
125325, then cut by
7. Dagobert 1000, turn left heading 320.
13055, thank you very much. Thank you very much. I was having a total brain fart then. I couldn't find it on the on VPilot. That's usually on a backup if I mess up.
Nearly over the ILS 2, that's the problem. I didn't saw you between all the departures.
Wait, what? What is the aircraft doing?
This is 2 Echo 9, and continue climb flight level 210. Continue climb flight level 210, Swiss 2 Echo 9. East 314, contact clock number 123.275, bye bye.
What the heck did it just do? Why did it turn like that? That's wild. Direct departure, City Island 610, level at 5000, Degas 5 Lima departure.
Traffic.
Station calling again.
City Island 610, level at 5,000, Degas 5, Lima departure.
City Island 610, City Island, hello, you're currently doing some strange maneuvers, turn left heading 080 for traffic avoidance.
Left heading 080, yeah, my apologies. I'm just trying to fix it, but yeah, thank you for the vector, City Island 610.
And City Island 610, climb flight level 120, expedite.
Climb flight level 120, expediting City Island 610.
Right, this is the 1457.
Okay then, guys. So we are going flight level 120. We shall go to speed mode. We'll go back to climb power. So we've got climb 209. We're going to put the flaps all the way up now. And we're going to climb at 210 knots to expedite the climb as requested by the controller. And we are going to go to standard altimeter as we're cleared up to a flight level. We can disarm the reversers now. And we're out. Let's go. We've got all those aircraft down there. Amazing. Squawk 7500. No, we don't do that. You don't do that with VATSIM, dude.
Lufthansa 477, I don't have you anymore on my radar screen. Report your position.
That's a timeout, dude. That's a timeout. Okay, so 10,000 feet. Let's get the nose lights and the landing lights off. We'll keep the seatbelt signs on for now, just in case we get any more sharp turns. Let's increase the speed now to 280 knots.
I can't give you vectors because you're not anymore on my screen.
Guys, I'll catch up with the chat in just a second. Just want to try and smooth things over and get established in the climb here. Because the Aerosoft CRJ has really screwed me over there. Really made me look like an absolute turd pilot.
Zero proceed direct Romga climb flight level 220.
Direct Romga climb 220, City Island 610. Someone else on the frequency we're picking up. So we're going direct to Romga, which is going to cut off this turn. Let's execute. Climb 280, heading. Is it going to climb?
India Mike Charlie Fox maintaining 5,000 feet.
Hello?
Delta India Charlie, correction, Delta India Mike Charlie Fox, City Rival, hello, you're identified, climb flight.
There we go. Finally started to respond. So we're going to go climb 290, heading. Actually, we want to be on nav because we've just got a direct, so we'll go nav. We've got a couple of aircraft just off the nose here. Let's see if we can see them. We cannot.
Speed 210 knots, scale 969.
Right, guys. I think I can look at the chat again in a moment. I think I can look at the chat in a moment, but let's just see how this goes, because I don't want to upset this controller anymore, because I've already mucked up once. Well, I'm only going to take half the blame for that, because it was mostly the autopilot that screwed me there, but at the same time, I should have been paying a little bit more attention, but I'm sure you can appreciate it. It's quite a lot to be paying attention to at the moment. Look at the snow-covered Alps over here. Oh, I tell you what it is, guys. It's this second radio. God damn it. It's because the CRJ, for some reason, you can't have this radio. You can't tune this radio to a frequency where it's not going to receive. You can't turn off the receiving for whatever reason. No matter what I do with these knobs, you can't turn the receiving off on this radio. So that's what we were hearing there. So I apologize for that, guys. Let's just set this to 1, 2, 3. We'll just set it to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0. Okay, we can probably expect a further climb clearance soonish. Right then, guys. Right then. How are we doing, chat? How are we doing? Holy crap, there's a lot of people in here. Welcome to the stream. Hope we're doing well. If you're enjoying the content, make sure you hit the thumbs up on YouTube. That really, really, really helps out the stream. So I appreciate that if you do consider doing that. I can see there's 85 people watching and only 47 likes. So there's definitely some people who haven't liked it. All right, so you might have just heard the altitude horn there. So we're leveling off. Let's bring back the power a bit here. No auto thrust in the CRJ, so we've always got to keep our eye on that speed. So we're taking a left turn here. It's doing something weird again. He gave us a direct to Romga, and it's just kind of cut off that corner, but let's just let it do its thing for now. How long is the flight? It's about an hour from here. Oh god, the CRJ is really not doing me any favours today. It's not impressing me. Okay, I can't see any clouds above us anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and turn the anti-ice off. Go ahead and turn the seatbelt signs off now as well. We'll turn the crossflow off as well. I think we could do our after takeoff checklist now. One, two, three, 275, City Island 610. Thank you for your patience. Bye. I'm just going to use this now, because those dials are too slow.
1, 2, 3, 275.
1, 9, speed on conversion, 2, 5, 7, 0, 9, 8, Romeo. 1, 9, speed on conversion, 2, 5, 7, 0. 1, conversion, 250, this is Banana. Lang and radar, good enough, it's Ryanair, 46 kilo, Juliet, Sombra, 1, Lima, departure.
I should really get in touch with this controller here. I'm just messing around with the cameras. I didn't hear that guy respond. Maybe it was too far away. Langen radar, Guten Abend. City Island 610, level at flight level 220, inbound Alago.
City Island 610, Langen, north. Contact line, what is 4075?
Say again, frequency for City Island 610.
City Island 610, Rhein Radar 134075.
134075, City Island 610.
Flight level, reach summit, flight level 240, Condor 1461.
25, the red summit.
It's so busy. Ryan Radar, Guten Abend, City Island 610, flight level 220 inbound Minga.
City Island 610, Ryan, hello, identified. Climate level 360.
Climb level 360, City Island 610. Okay, finally got a bit more of a climb clearance there, so 360. Which I believe is our final cruising altitude, if I remember correctly. So we'll go back to speed mode. I'm just going to toggle it on and off so it actually works this time. Give it a bit more power into the climb detent. Nose is pitching up. There we go, beautiful stuff. So we'll go climb 290, Alt S, white. And then we've got flight level 360, magenta.
Climb flight level 310, 3609.
Every 609, contact the radar 123275, provide.
Our cruising altitude is actually 370, so we'll see what happens.
I'm sorry, 609?
123275.
3275.
Alright, chat. I can catch up with chat now. Holy crap, that lasted that was so busy, guys. It's not it's very rare that it's actually this busy, so I'm actually surprised by how many people have actually stuck around and that are still here. So thank you everyone for sticking with me if you've been here for a while. Hope you guys are enjoying nevertheless. Alright, let's see. Mariner, how are you doing, dude? Are you still on the ground? What time have I got set? I'm on the... what time am I on? I'm on 14:36 Zulu currently. Canvat Sim see you as we can. No, they can't. No, they will see us on a like a radar scope, like you would in the real world. Sean Gray, welcome to the chat over on Facebook. Hope you're doing well. I am doing very well. Yeah, thank you for asking. Jonathan Math asks, how long will the flight be? It'll be about an hour from now. I think I mentioned that earlier. Let's see. So Yahya says, I'm so hyped for July the 3rd. I'm intrigued for that. Yahya, I don't know what is on July the 3rd. I must be missing something here.
2137, contact the radar, 123.925, bye-bye.
Dennis, welcome to the chat from Brazil. Hope you're doing well.
Maintain flight level 410, checking in.
The 411 Ryan, hello.
Rates on COQ, no idea what that is. Hyperion. Do I know any jokes? Alright, guys, are you ready? Here's my joke. So, a man walks into a bar. Ouch. Safety video. Oh no, we don't do safety videos usually. Sometimes we have the audio because of on self-loading cargo. But we don't usually do safety videos because it's just annoying while I'm streaming and trying to taxi and stuff at the same time. Aviation 001, thank you very much for the sub, dude. Thank you so much.
189, we've got flight level 340.
I think I missed quite a few notifications here. Yo, Sandreb, thank you very much for the £5 UAE 160 on VATSIM. Dude, thank you so much. That's very generous. Was that you who was in Zurich, crossing the runway that we saw?
150 second waypoint, please hold from here,
Sierra. Oh, and DK as well for the 10, coming in with a £10 tip as well. Thank you so much, guys. I apologize the notification didn't show on the screen. I have it set so that when I'm sort of, I've got the hand camera up. I've got it set so no notification appears, so it's not sort of distracting me whilst I'm trying to take off and whatnot. So sorry about that, but thank you so much for the £10 tip, DK. That's very, very generous of you. Yeah, thank you so much. Absolute legend. Anyone else who's liked the stream on Facebook and or YouTube as well, I can see there's a few more likes come in there. Really appreciate that, guys. That's very, very cool of you. And for the subs as well, Donuts and Wings, thank you so much for the sub, as well as Lilo, Robert, and Slime Games as well. Thank you very much for the subs on YouTube. Much appreciated. Let's see where we are. So we're still climbing. Should be a little while yet. CRJ tends to climb pretty poorly at these higher altitudes, but we'll see how we get on. Half bank mode has just come on. We're on climb Mach 0.79. So I'm actually going to reduce the speed to Mach 0.74. Gives us a slightly higher climb rate as well. All right, so let's see what else we've got. What camera do we want, guys? I think we want this one. I'm feeling that one. I'm feeling that one. Let's see. What else? Earth from Above. That was you in the Euro Wings. Amazing, dude. Amazing. That was a good livery as well. Sandrib, thank you very much for the sub on YouTube. Thank you very much, dude. Much appreciated. Which Xbox do I have? I'm not playing on an Xbox, Per Johnson. We are on PC. Yeah, I have no idea what that guy was doing on the ground, Mariner. No idea. Alright, we're about to level off. Oh, why did I get the 1,000 to go horn there? Oh, the heck? I'm sure that just said 3-2 a second ago. Okay, look at all this flickering. That's very annoying. Right, okay, we are looking good. I'm just going to come in here and just turn off the airports because that's cluttering up that screen.
Good evening, excellent. 260 inbound Lapu and maintaining 240.
Wow, it's really struggling to do this final bit of the climb, isn't it? I probably reduced the power too much too early.
Ryan Control, good evening. Skydiver 121, climbing flight level 300, point expand level 287.
Skydiver 121. But yes, Earth from Above, to answer your question, that was, yeah, player on VATSIM. I'm not sure if I answered that one earlier on.
Confirm your stairs, set on second, please.
Bill, how are you doing, brother?
Skydiver,
yeah, doing very well, mate. Hope you're doing well as well.
From Sierra, hold over Zunek, inbound course will be 180, right hand turn.
Right, there we go, we've got alt cap.
180 inbound, right hand turn. Can you confirm that waypoint again, go from here, Sierra?
Next one.
Right, cool.
Hold over Zunek and go from here, Sierra.
650, hold over Zunek, inbound course
180. Topley asks, what joystick is that? So this is a VKB Gladiator NXT joystick. It's very, very good. Very, very good. I used to have the TCA side stick by Thrustmaster, and whilst that is okay, it's got this very, very hard spring in it, so it springs back to center like super, super fast, and it has a lot of tension in it. I didn't really like that. And on this one, there's far less tension and it kind of moves around a little bit more realistically, like an actual side stick would do in an aircraft. But yes, you're right, Topley, in the throttle. The throttle was is the Thrustmaster TCA quadrant and add-on. All of my hardware is in the description of the video, so if you go down below the video and click see more, you can actually see all of my hardware down there.
Inbound 180 and right turn, time 1.5 minutes. Swiss 9164.
Skyman 602, request further climb.
602, climb level 340.
Climb flight level 340.
Chris Scott, welcome to the chat. Hope you're doing well. Welcome, welcome. I'm doing well, thanks. Yeah, how are you doing, Chris? Finally, yes, indeed, we finally got going. Such is the life of a real pilot, I imagine. Brian, welcome to the chat. Hope you're doing well, buddy. Good to see you. Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Brian Radar, with 105, level 360.
I knew someone would comment on this one. We always get someone commenting on this. It's funny though, because like when I fly the Airbus aircraft, I actually fly on this side. But any other aircraft, I just fly on this side because it's a yoke, isn't it? You know, it's. I'm already missing a yoke, so there it is. I appreciate you guys giving me the frequency as well, by the way, when I was totally flapping there when the autopilot fluffed up on me. I hope you guys saw what it was doing there. I hope you guys saw what the autopilot was doing. So it had in... I can't really show you on the ND right now. Or can I? No, I can't. Okay. So, yeah, it had in like a turn to intercept the leg. And what it did was, rather than sort of doing a nice smooth turn to the left, it did a super sharp turn to come in on like a very, very sharp intercept with the next leg, which it shouldn't have done, really. I imagine the real aircraft would do a much smoother turn coming out. So that was not what I was expecting it to do. But obviously I was trying to talk on the radios and everything whilst trying to pay attention to what the aircraft is doing. So that's probably why that controller gave me a vector there, because it was just not going well. So I appreciate that. But thanks for giving me the frequency, guys. Am I doing a giveaway soon? I'd not planned on one, no. I'd not planned on one, but maybe. Maybe soon. I can't really confirm or deny. I would like to do more giveaways, but it's just, you know, when I can. I don't tend to get a lot of products to give away, and my own budget is limited. But yes, Chris, very, very busy in Zurich. Very busy. Clem Tim as well, bonjour, welcome to the stream, hope you're doing well. Welcome from France. Hey, Cedric lives in Zurich, amazing dude. Is it that busy at Zurich at this time normally?
An 86 uniform descent level 260, hold over Tesco, inbound course setting 230, left turn 1.5 minute and right hand turn.
Correct.
City Island 610, request flight level 370.
City Island 610, standby for high end traffic.
Roger. Okay. Yeah, so someone asked earlier on about VATSIM making mistakes. Oh, there we go. It was the next message I was about to read. Oh, no. What is my favorite aircraft? That's the next one. yeah, difficult question. I don't really know, to be honest with you. I'm really not sure. I don't know. I mean, my go-to generally when someone asks that question is the A380. But I've got no bearing on why that's my favorite aircraft, apart from the fact that it's just an amazing piece of engineering and it's the biggest commercial passenger aircraft. but I don't know. I don't know. You have to leave that one with me. And Cloud Surfer asks, do they ever get mad and VATSIM if you do mistakes? I'm nervous to try it. That's the point. Actually, we'll put TCAS to above and below currently. Apparently, I've got traffic above me, he says. Can't see any, but they might be a bit further away. Anyways, so... I wouldn't say they get mad. Most of them are quite helpful. Some of them, when it's very, very busy and you make... Sometimes when it's very, very busy and you make mistakes, then it can be a bit stressful for the controllers because they've obviously got a lot of stuff to do. So if you're obviously new to VATSIM, I would much more recommend going to a quiet location rather than flying one of these vents. And most of the time, if it's quiet, yeah, they are very much happy to help you out and are very, very kind and really friendly. So... Yeah, I wouldn't say they get mad, but maybe a bit stressed out if there's a scenario where they're very busy and someone clearly doesn't know what they're doing. So, yeah, you can also ask Mariner Halley in the chat. He is a YouTuber here and streaming on Facebook, Twitch, and YouTube. He's also a controller as well. So feel free to give him a shout. Mariner, I am going to mod you as well. I don't know if you're still in the chat.
Flight level 260, Lufthansa
650. Swiss Rainrider, guten Abend, Kajak 65, inbound Maastricht, flight level.
Yo, Football Extra, why are you spamming the chat, dude? That's a timeout. Wow. Right, so next up, Topley says, I'm quite new on VATSIM, but so far I've made many mistakes from taxi to landing, and the ATZ have always been helpful. Yeah, exactly, so there you go. There you go, Cloud Surfer. Bruno, yeah, I've had similar problems with the CRJ in the past, but I've never had anything quite as catastrophic as that, to be quite honest with you. Amin, Ruben wants to be a pilot, can say hi to him. Ruben, hello, dude. Do it. You should become a pilot, dude. It's amazing. I'm not a pilot, but clearly it's a lot of fun. Oh, Ufram, no way. How that was you in the departure. Amazing. How are you guys finding the stream from us being on the same departure there? That's crazy. But, yeah, no worries at all, dude. No worries at all. Thank you guys for telling Football Extra. I don't know why he felt like he could just spam the chat and it's going to change anything. Winter Splash, we are on frequency 134075. Yeah. Oh, you backed out, Mariner. No worries at all, dude. No worries at all. Cloud Surfer asks, if the CRJ doesn't have auto throttle, what does the speed button at the autopilot do? So it's a vertical mode, basically, Cloud Surfer. So when you press speed, it will basically climb at a given speed. So it's a bit like in a GA aircraft, it's a bit like flight level change in a Boeing or flight level change in a GA aircraft, something like that. And you could probably liken it to a selected speed climb on the Airbus as well.
Tower,
Well, yeah, there's a great explanation. Speed button keeps speed using pitch, and generally you use it in the climb in the CRJ.
Mention 139.525 for easy to see numbers.
This man really saved my life.
1, 2, 3,
amazing.
5,
Football Extra, hello to yourself who tune is here. I don't even know if you're still here or not.
Swiss 901 Echo, Christian Swiss 901-916, Echo descent level
270.
Climbing Tim, thank you very much for the sub as well on YouTube. Much appreciated. Thank you very much. I don't think we're going to get this new flight level that I requested here, to be honest. I requested flight level 370 because that's our planned altitude, but he doesn't seem to want to give me it. We might have to just reprogram the VNAV. But we'll see how we get on. We've still got quite a while to go yet until we have to descend, so we'll just hang on for now. Climb 370, City Island 610. Thank you very much. All right, great stuff. Speak of the devil, we actually got our climb there. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go for a vertical speed climb. So we'll set 370 vertical speeds, and we'll just go for 500 feet per minute.
Swiss 975, flight level 280.
Swiss 975, Rhein radar, hello, identified.
Please say again, frequency for Lufthansa 650.
650, radar 123275.
I can't quite get the throttles in the right spot. I forgot to take the detents out of my throttle quadrant, and they keep slipping in between the detents and out of them. Oh, stop it. I'm just going to take the detents out. One sec. Get the old screwdriver out. I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, why is he taking the detents out when the CRJ has detents? But it's basically because these detents, they're okay, but they're not the greatest. There we go. So basically what happens is when you put the throttle levers near a detent, there's like a little sort of, you could call it a dead zone, I suppose. And what happens is the throttle quad, the throttles, they actually move on their own slightly because they're kind of half in the detent and half not. So you end up with a scenario where the throttles move on their own, which you don't want in the CRJ because it's obviously manual throttles. So I'm just taking the detents out. Right. F14 man, yeah, I've given him a timeout, and if he continues, then we'll just ban him. It's always so busy on VATSIM. Yeah, I mean, the last couple of times I've flown on VATSIM, we've done events, so yeah, it is very busy. Right, there we go. Alt S, and we are level at 370. Beautiful.
125.05.
Where are we over now? That's a good question. Let's see. We are probably over. Look at that contrail. Beautiful. Looks like we're approaching. Oh, that's cloud there, isn't it? That's not water. So we're probably over southern Germany, somewhere over that area. Let me just have a quick look on the map. Yeah, we're just east of Frankfurt at the moment. And you guys will be pleased to know is we actually have full controller coverage all the way until, well, till the north of Germany, basically. And unfortunately, we don't have a controller on for Copenhagen. Maybe they come online. We'll see.
12327, five, this was 906 Echo.
Tag 65, nothing further, Unicom, bye bye.
All right.
Swiss 66, descend level 330.
Descend flight level 330, Swiss 66.
Will and Mariner, I modded you both, I think. So if that guy starts spamming again, if I don't catch it, then please do feel free to ban him.
411, nothing further, you can come, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Hello to Connie as well, Bruno. Hello. Arrow, welcome to the chat as well. Welcome, welcome. I hope you're doing well. What is going on with the shadows? Yeah, I'm not sure, to be honest. It's a bit of a bug with the CRJ. It sometimes happens in this cockpit for some reason.
611, can we need the cockpit now for 5 minutes?
Autopilot looks fine to us. I'm sure it did. Yeah, it was a bit embarrassing that, to be honest with you, because it's something that, you know, I expected the aircraft to do one thing, and we did check it. We checked it against the charts and everything looked okay, and then it did something completely different. So yeah, it's just a bit annoying really. I think if I wasn't flying on a busy VATSIM event, I probably would have caught that a bit earlier and put myself onto heading mode so that I wasn't turned in such a way that he had to give us a vector. You know, I was fumbling with the radios and I was trying to put in my climb speed, and yeah, it was 128075, CTRN 610, thank you, bye. Alright, 128075. I think that was a frequency anyway. You guys will come to learn very quickly if you're new to the channel that I'm pretty terrible at remembering frequencies for centers especially. But that is the correct frequency. Ryan Radar, Guten Abend, City Island 610, flight level 370, inbound Robel.
Yeah, 610, Ryan Radar, hello, identified.
There we go, beautiful. I got the call sign right as well. Gotta love it. I always get confused with Ryan Radar and what's the other one as well in this area of the world? Langen. Winter Splash, hope you're doing well, by the way, buddy. Welcome, welcome. Your BAW787 and heard you on voice, instantly knew it was you. That's amazing, dude. That's amazing. That's awesome, dude. Brilliant. Well, I hope you're enjoying your flight anyway, dude. Whereabouts are you going? Yo, FSX Genius. Is that for me, ALP? Oh, look how smooth my frame rate is in this area. Because I don't think I've ever played FSX. Well, I know I haven't. Manicle, welcome back, dude. I hope you're doing well. Welcome, welcome, welcome. The flight is it's going all right. It's going all right. We had a bit of a weird... I don't know. The autopilot did some weird stuff on the departure, and that was a bit annoying. But other than that, yeah, pretty nice. Very nice scenes here in the south of Germany. I wonder if any captain in real life had it. Someone asked about his favourite plane so many times in quick succession. Yeah, I wonder as well. I wonder. You should be a pilot, Bob. I'd get on the plane for the pure butteriness. I love it. I love it. Is the controller watching the stream? I'm not sure. I'm not sure. Nice screwdriver, thank you. Hey, 22, let's go. More than 70 viewers, still over 70. Holy crap, guys. Well, welcome. I think Manicle, at one point, we had 100 viewers here just before we departed, which is crazy. Where are you guys all come from? I'm actually genuinely interested. How have you guys, if you're new to the stream today, how did you manage to find the stream? I'm intrigued. Crazy lighting, must be the sun reflecting on the metal on the wing. Yeah, sometimes it is a reflection, sometimes it's a bit of a graphical glitch. Like, you can see how the shadow's like flickering a bit here. I'm not sure that is supposed to be like that. I think that's some kind of aliasing issue, I think, something like that. What's the pilot doing with that screwdriver? Hey, I mean, all good pilots bring a screwdriver to work with them, don't they? Just a little in-flight DIY. Yeah, mate, just a bit of maintenance, you know? We didn't have time to do it before departure, so, you know, just thought we'd take care of these maintenance items just before we, just while we're in the cruise here. Why not?
Top dono lol.
Hey, Sandreb, dude. Thank you very much for the £6 tip. Much appreciated. That's very generous of you. Thank you so much. Absolute legend. All right, let's see. Let me have another drink, please. You're welcome, mate. You're welcome. You don't need to know what's going on up here. I'm flying over the Rhone National Park right now. Amazing. Good to know. Well, it looks very nice anyway, doesn't it? Very nice indeed. Yeah, that's a shame, that Mariner, isn't it? It would be great to have a controller on when we arrive in Copenhagen after this amazing departure. Chicago Skyhawk, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are in the world. Welcome to the chat. Hope you're doing well. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Who thinks Bob should wear a pilot cap? Guys, Bill, please don't egg him on, please. I'll take the shades, though. I might wear some shades sometime. I can wear some shades. In fact, I've actually got some glasses here. I can put my glasses on. That kind of doubles as... that's almost as cool, right? Glasses is just as cool as wearing sunglasses, right? Right? No? Maybe not? I don't know. We should tip and mandate. He must use them to buy a first officer outfit. I mean, if you guys want to do that, you know, I mean, I'm... If you're gonna fund the purchase, then I will do that for you guys. Found a nice little combo pack on Amazon. Oh God, is that the text that you just sent me? Stream showed up on the homepage. Right, got you. Thank you for that. Same for Clem Tim. Got you. All right, well, thank you very much for that, guys. Thank you. Davi, unfortunately, I can only speak English. We only really do English in the chat. So I can't read what you're saying there, I'm afraid. Shadow on the wing will be from the heat blur from the engine. That's a very good point, actually. Yeah, it most likely is, isn't it? Yeah, because right on this side... Yeah, that's the engine right there, isn't it, I suppose? Yeah. Yeah, so I guess that does make sense then, doesn't it? Ord is home. I just realised we haven't got any music on. It's gone very quiet. Cord is home. Amazing, dude. Okay, so you're from Cord, Chicago, I guess, right? Aviators or nothing. Well, I don't have any aviators I can put on right now. You have been chosen by the YouTube algorithm. I've been chosen. Oh no, we're losing speed because I'm not paying attention. I'm actually just going to go straight back to climb power for now, because we've lost a decent amount of speed there. Although, funnily enough, even at this altitude for the CRJ, it's still got quite a big sort of speed range it can fly at. The stall speed isn't super high like it would be on some of the heavier airliners. But I bet it's not gonna accelerate at all at this point. No, it's not really accelerating now. Oops. Yeah, that's my bad. I should have been paying attention there, but I'm going to blame you guys for that. Why in the hell are you teaching people how to fly a plane on Facebook or on any place? Excuse me, Linda? You can learn how to fly a plane on way more places than Facebook. And flight simulation is quite a popular hobby, Linda. So it's not really something new, and not something that's definitely come around after 9/11. It's definitely been around for much longer than then. Oliver, where am I from? I am from the north of England, from West Yorkshire in the UK. Dave has a pilot shirt I can have. Don't say that, Dave, please. I'm trying to slyly avoid this scenario from occurring. But yeah, Linda, we have obviously every respect for, you know, what happened on 9/11. But, you know, I don't think necessarily teaching people how to fly a plane is really going to contribute to that. In fact, do you really need to know how to fly a plane if you want to commit those atrocities?
Good day, welcome 642, flight level 390. 642, Ryan, good night, identified. Sorry, Ryan, welcome 642. Come on, welcome 642, Dyke Class of Hero Lima Foxport. Dyke Class of you, welcome 642, thank you.
Ryan, LOF 411.
Right, okay. Right then, let's start getting ready for the arrival then, because we're actually looking pretty good. We are accelerating nicely, actually. That's good. So, that's good. We'll pull the thrust levers just back slightly into the climb cruise detent. Just so it doesn't accelerate too quickly, and we shall do a bit of an approach briefing. So let me just double check on flight radar. I'm just going to check what runway is actually in use at Copenhagen at the moment, because we don't unfortunately have a controller on there right now. So there's going to be no ATIS, etc. So we'll have to just... direct Monac, City Island 610. Okay, we've got a direct there. Nice. Nice little cut off that corner. So let's execute. And there we go. We're back on speed. So let's just find out what runway is in use at Copenhagen. It looks like 22 left. Yeah, pretty sure it's 2-2 left. I'm just going to watch this other aircraft come in for a landing. I'm pretty sure they don't use 2-2 right for landings anyway, because it's involves overflying the airfield or the terminal. Let's see, is there a controller on? Oh, there is actually a controller on now. There's a tower controller on, but there's still no ATIS. Okay, that's fine. No worries, no worries. Oh, thank you for the meta as well, Mariner. Much appreciated, dude. The clouds seem to look far better since the update. Yeah, they're... 133025, City Island 610. Thank you. Bye bye. That was what he told me, wasn't it? Yes, it was. And we're going to slow down a bit now. Ryan Radar, Goodenham and City Island 610, flight level 370, direct Monarch.
City Island 610, I'm Radar, hello, identified.
Okay, great stuff. It's very quiet on these frequencies for a change. It's usually pretty busy on these centres over Germany. Look at this though, this is looking very funky. Now, I'm not sure what that shadow is coming off, because that one's a bit strange, isn't it? Obviously it's coming in this window here. Look at that, that looks nice though, doesn't it? So yeah, oh look, another plane down there. You see the green light there? Love to see it. All right, so we are going to do a approach briefing. We're about just under 100 miles from our top of descent, so we shall go ahead and do a briefing now. All right, so we've got the fuzz pads.
My hey, little contribution yo, Manicle. To your success, winking face.
Dude, you're an absolute gent. Thank you very much for the £3 tip. You're an absolute legend. Thank you very much. Very, very generous. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Rubens, welcome from Brazil. Hope you're doing well. Okay. Okie dokie, great stuff. So yeah, Darren, that is results in that in the CRJ, but we seem to have resolved the situation in this instance. Probably because we're not. Well, this is the CRJ 9, so I believe it does have slightly more powerful engines than the CRJ 7 that I'm more familiar with. And yeah, we're looking good. Right, anyways, fuzzpad, let's bring up the charts here. I assume you guys can see the charts now. Yes, you can. All right, so we are currently, as you can see, we've just got a direct to it was Norbury, wasn't it? Oh, it was Monarch actually, wasn't it? So Monarch is right here, the initial fix for the approach. So we've just got a really good shortcut all the way off this corner here, so that's quite nice. Now then, I've planned for the Monarch 2 Charlie arrival into the airfield here at Copenhagen, and we can use this for 2-2 left, which is good. So let's see. So
inbound Reckon.
So Monarch 2 Charlie, which is going to take us down this right branch. So Monarch itself has no restrictions as such, and we've got the Codan VOR just following immediately afterwards, 4 miles to be exact, and then we're going to take a right turn. Excuse me, track 031 out towards Nexo. And Monarch 2 Charlie is going to be below flight level 100 at Nexo, which is in the box already. So I will we'll look at the FMS in coordination with the charts in a moment, guys. But that's that. Airport elevation itself is 17 feet, so we'll have to make sure we adjust that on the cabin pressure, which I'm actually just going to do right now before I forget. And then I'll review everything in a moment. Right, so that's the star, the standard arrival, and then we'll go ahead and come to the final approach charts. So we're going to go for runway 22 left here at Copenhagen. Okay, so this is the ILS chart for the runway 22 left at Copenhagen. So looking at this, we've got the ILS frequency 109.5. Final approach course 217 degrees. Airport elevation 17 feet, runway elevation 8 feet. We've also got a transition altitude of 5,000 feet. Transition level is what we'll need to pay attention to, but considering we don't have a controller on, we'll just treat the transition level as 5,000 as well. Okay, cool. So the procedure itself takes us in over the VOR, then out and round to the right and in onto the ILS. However, what we're going to do for this one is we'll probably vector ourselves, which is probably what would happen in real life. As you can see here, this arrival chart, it ends here. So you would get put onto vectors from there. You can see here, it doesn't actually say there. Sometimes it says up here, expect vectors after such a point, but it doesn't. So yeah, we'll just vector ourselves up to the north here and then round to the left, rather than flying this procedure, because this is just, it's just not going to work for us. It's just going to be annoying to fly that, and you probably wouldn't fly that in real life. So moving on, descent angle is 3 degrees and the minimums are 208 feet, and that's it really. It's a fairly straightforward ILS. There's nothing too special about it. The ILS itself has DME, so we don't necessarily need to tune this VOR. However, for the missed approach, we'll climb straight ahead to 500 feet or 1 mile from the OXS VOR, which is tucked in there as well. Oh, sorry, OXS is the ILS identifier, isn't it? My bad. So DME 1 from the ILS, whichever is later, and then turn left onto 187, climbing to 3000 and inform ATC. So in terms of that go-around procedure, we are probably going to reach 500 feet before we reach 1 mile. So we'll most likely just do the left turn at 500 feet if we need to go around, which hopefully we won't do. MSA is variable, so 1600 and 1700 in the south and northeast sectors. That's going to concern us for this approach. I'll probably draw that in on the ND as well, just to have that there. If you can do that in this aircraft, I can't remember if you can. And then after landing,
identified.
After landing, we're going to take a right off the runway. We're probably going to vacate Bravo 4, I imagine. Maybe Bravo 5 if we're lucky, but probably with the CRJ, it'll be Bravo 4 because there's no auto brake. And then we'll take a right onto Bravo, and then most likely our taxi clearance. I'm going to request stand at Bravo 17, which is the real stand that this flight landed at yesterday when it landed. So we're going to land at Bravo 17. Sorry, Bravo 15. Bravo 15 for the stand. So we can basically expect a taxi straight up Bravo, and then Bravo will come to here. We'll cross the runway. We might get a left turn. Let's have a look. Yeah, so we might get a left turn onto Delta, but I doubt it. Usually they send... actually, yeah, maybe we will. I don't know. We could go left here onto Delta or straight forward onto Bravo. And then we'll take a left. Left onto Zulu or Yankee. Not sure which one they would send us on. But it would be a left turn and then onto the stand, which is fairly straightforward. All right. So that is the arrival in a nutshell. We are coming up on our top of descent, about 70 miles away. So let's just have a double check, make sure everything is actually in the box properly. So let's just refresh right here. So like so. Okay, so we had a restriction at Nexo, which is in 250 knots and below flight level 100, so that's all in there, that's fine. And then that's it, really. There's no other restrictions. So what I usually like to do is make sure the final approach fix for the ILS is incorrectly. Final approach fix in this instance is the 5 miles from the runway here, which is FI22 right, which is 1600. That is in, and I'm actually going to change this this fix right here as well to. We're just going to change that to required altitude of 3000 rather than 3000 or above. So that's in there, and the missed approach is in there as well with 3000 feet and vectors. So that's all in, and we're pretty much ready for the approach. Any questions? It's gone very purple in the flight deck here, hasn't it? It's going to be probably dark when we arrive, I imagine. It's very, very quiet on this frequency as well. I'm not used to this. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. CRJ900, much longer range. Yeah, certainly does. Certainly does. Welcome to Denmark. Yeah, thank you very much, Thomas Rask. Yeah, absolutely love flying into Copenhagen. Yeah, I think what we're actually going to do is, when we arrive... how can I show you guys? Bear with me. Bring the fuzz pad back up, and I think I can... Well, I can just show you on the charts, I suppose, can't I? So if we look on the ILS chart, you can see the bridge there. The, what is it called? The Øresund Bridge, I think. So we're actually going to fly directly over that. We'll fly sort of across this way, over the bridge, take a left turn in. Should be pretty cool. Going to do as well is I'm just going to have a quick look on Volanta and just see what my departure route was. Oh my god, that's a mess. So Manicle, if you're wondering what happened on the departure, I'll show you. Actually, no, I can't easily show you here. Here we go. Right, okay, it's massive. Oh dear. There we are. Look at that. So what I would have expected the aircraft to do actually here is come out here like this. It did this first part correct, and then it started making the left turn. That was correct. But what I would have expected it to do is carry on sort of turning around not that sharply and then come in and re-intercept the outbound course here. Whereas what it did was it actually turned very sharply to intercept a course that went out this way. So... yeah, it was a bit annoying that, but as you can see, the rest of the departure was okay. You can even see our taxi route there. And there's still a lot of aircraft there. You can see those little planes there. They are actually other aircraft on VATSIM. Still very, very busy at Zurich. So looking at where we are, we're currently just passing over the north side of Germany. And yeah, we're pretty much there. We're just going to pass over... this sea, I forget the name of the sea, and down into Copenhagen. And as you can see, there is a bit of weather hanging over the airport, so this should be an interesting arrival. CRJ needs some fine tuning. Yeah, it does a bit, doesn't it? I don't know. The thing is, I'm not even sure if they're gonna refine the autopilot anymore. I heard a lot of people say that the P3D version had the exact same issue, so that doesn't really fill with a lot of confidence. Hate to say it. All right, we are going to start our descent, so let's ask the controller and see if we can do that. City Island 610 is ready for descent.
City Island 610, descent flight level 290, rate 1,500 or greater.
Descent 290, rate 1,500 or greater, City Island 610. All right. 290 and a rate of 1,500 or more, which should be more than doable. So I'll start off with 1,500, bring the throttles back a bit. Going to get a bit of lighting on there in the cockpit as well. Get the floor lights on for the inevitable point where I drop my screwdriver and it goes rolling under the pedals. Alright, so we're going to go 1,500 or greater. We need to reach Nexo by... We want to be under flight level 100 by Nexo, didn't we? So in order to achieve that constraint, 1,500 is actually the required descent rate. So we'll stay at that. And we're about to hit the top of descent. So we start descent just a touch early there, which is fine. Let me just have a quick look here. So we'll bring up the VNAV window here and we'll just have a look. So Nexo, flight level 100 below, 108 miles to go. And I tell you what I'm going to do is I am just going to delete this vectors leg and just make sure that's not screwing with the VNAV, because sometimes it can cause issues with the VNAV when you've got vector legs or anything like that in there. So let's go like that. So 1,500, that's still absolutely fine. But you can see here how it's changed now. Nexo has now changed to flight level 100. Unless I was reading that totally wrong before. For some reason before it said 3,000, which was confusing me. But removing that vectors leg seems to have fixed the situation. And we can actually have a bit more power for the descent here, because we are even slowing down at this relatively shallow descent rate. Yeah, it's going to be a fairly shallow descent. Maybe I shouldn't have asked him. Say again, frequency for City Island 610. 123-225, City Island 610. Thank you. Bye bye. He reeled that off so quickly. Holy. Bremen radar, Guten Abend, City Island 610, flight level 330, descending flight level 290. City Island 610. Alright, my bad. He said call sign only. Did the previous controller advise me of that? I can't remember if he did or not. Oh, we've got an ATIS now at Copenhagen. This is where they tell me they're using a different runway. Let's see. Visual approach on request. Haha, let's do it, guys. Arrival runway is 22 left. That's fine.
Bravo Charlie Yankee, 610, descent flight to 200.
Alright. Is that for me?
Bravo Charlie Yankee 610, descend flight level 200.
Descend flight level 200, City Island 610. Okay, I guess he didn't know the long call sign for that for my airline. All right, cool. It runs so smoothly. I want that too. Yeah, it does run quite smoothly, the CRJ, when you're at a higher flight level. Twin Otter, yeah, I'll definitely be getting the Twin Otter, Chris. Yeah, 100%. I have a £20 voucher as well for Aerosoft that I still need to use, so I'll probably use it on that. Yo, Keegs Raid on Facebook. Welcome to the chat, guys. I hope we're doing well. You've tuned in at a perfect time. We've just started our descent into Copenhagen. As you can see, absolute scenes outside. Am I using the Fly Tampa scenery for Copenhagen? Generic Pilot asks. Yes, I am indeed. Yeah, beautiful. I love the Fly Tampa for Copenhagen. It's so, so good. Stinking screwdrivers. I have a really hard time with the CRJ on my approaches. The plane tends to pitch up as I slow down. It doesn't really do a great job of locking in on the ILS either. Yeah, I've seen a lot of people have issues with that. And I have had it on a couple of occasions, but not super frequently. But, yeah, you've just got to, I suppose you've just got to make sure you keep a close eye on that speed all times. Because if you get too slow, you will end up having a nose-up attitude. But at the end of the day, Andy, I've seen a lot of people say that same thing, to be quite honest with you. It is a little bit finicky to handle, and I think Aerosoft are aware of that. I think some of the behaviours are maybe a little bit too pronounced, but yeah, we'll see how we go today because I haven't flown the CRJ in quite a while either. So yeah, we'll see how it goes. What plane are we using? Just joined. We are using the CRJ9 or CRJ900 by Aerosoft. Welcome to the chat, though. Hope you're doing well. Anant, welcome as well. Hope you're doing well. Andy's tuned in for the end. Good, good man. I know now we've got loads of people watching. I'm probably just going to absolutely... just ruin the landing. It's going to be really, really sad. Hopefully not. My excuse is I haven't flown the CRJ in a while. That's one of my excuses. Second excuse is I'm using a different sensitivity setting than what I normally use. That's my second excuse. And I'll think of another one. I'll think of another one. But we're on our way down. No pressure, yeah, no pressure. We'll see. Let's see how it goes. One two two eight, City Island 610. I think he already contacted me once, but I talked over him. So my apologies, controller, if you're watching the stream. Sorry about that. I blame the chat. I really want another aircraft for Microsoft Flight Simulator with CP DLC, so we don't have this issue where I miss stuff. but as you can see, anyway, we're right on the profile here. We're right on the snowflake. And the blue donut. So we're looking fine on our descent profile. We're now no longer flying on a Mach number. So we could actually increase the speed a little bit here, but I don't really see the sense in doing that. We'll just keep it as it is for now. New air crash investigation coming. Hopefully not. I'll try and remember to turn on the replay as well. Someone remind me to turn on the replay when we get a bit closer. I've got it here in the toolbar this time, so... Speaking of air crash investigation, I've got a really, really cool idea lined up for the stream in the next couple of weeks, which is not necessarily going to be air crash investigation type stuff, but it's going to be pretty interesting, I think, and I think you guys will enjoy it. So make sure you stay tuned to the stream for that. Let's see, who that message from? Oh, it was from another aircraft, assuming they're arriving in Copenhagen. Speeds, he's asking. Let's see, what traffic have we got on the way in? So we've got a Scandinavian behind me. That is the guy who just messaged me. He's doing the same route, in fact, in an A321. I'll tell him that I can speed up, can increase if required. Okay, 1,000 to go. We're going to continue our descent here. So I'm going to put in altitude 3,000 feet. We're going to continue going right down onto this ILS. So altitude 3,000 feet is set, 3,000 magenta. We could definitely do with a bit more lighting in here because I'm having to use my torch. So let's get the dome light on. There we go. Is that better? It's still very dark, isn't it? But can I do 280? I can indeed, sir. Let's do 280. Eileen, welcome to the chat from Ireland. I hope you're doing well. Good to see you. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Only butter, please. Let's see what happens. Let's see. But yes, welcome, Eileen. Welcome. I do enjoy flying out of Dublin in this simulator. Very, very enjoyable experience. And pretty hairy weather as well. TCAS can just be on below for the descent. It'd be really nice if I had a weather radar and I could see down in front of me, but as you can see, it's more or less just blackness. I can see some clouds down there, but not a great deal. We'll have to definitely turn our anti-ice on as we get a bit closer in. Alright, so let's do our descent checklist anyway. So landing elevation is set. Set there to 20 feet, as I did when we were doing the briefing. Fuel is 2.5 tons, that is checked and okay. TCAS is set, radar is on. CAS is checked, as you can see, clear, no messages at all, looking good there. Landing data, is set. However, let's just double check. I'd not checked that we got the correct frequency in just yet, so let's make sure that's in there. So we need 109.5 for the ILS. That's not tuned, so let's go ahead and tune that now. So we'll put that in nav 1 and we'll put it in nav 2 as well. The 109.5 is set. Manual is set both sides as well. So that is good to go. Okay, so landing data is set. Our landing speeds are not set yet, but we're not going to do that until we get a little bit closer in. And approach briefing is complete, so descent checklist complete. Max, the specs for PC, they are in the description of the video. If you just press show more and scroll down a bit, everything is down there. Oh yes, weather is crap, yeah. Yeah, very marginal at times. Okay, so we are approaching Monarch, and we are on profile. We're looking good. As we said earlier on, our only constraint we need to pay attention to is Nexo at flight level 100 or below and 250 knots, which we are on profile for. We should be good there. Flew to from Copenhagen on, to Copenhagen from Hamburg on an SAS CRJ 900 a few years ago. Nice generic pilot, nice dude. Yeah, I had someone else earlier say that they flew Zurich to Copenhagen, also to somewhere, I can't remember where, also to Copenhagen maybe on a CRJ as well. And yeah, very, very cool. I've never actually flown on a CRJ in real life. Would like to, for sure. Glad you're enjoying it, Paul. Glad you're enjoying it. We do try. That's okay, Max. No worries at all. It's a bit hidden away by YouTube, isn't it? All right. It's just pitch black outside now. Can see the nice sunset still. That's about it. Pitch black on this side almost. And it's cloudy, so we can't see any city lights either. Okay, we're a little bit below profile here, but that is absolutely fine because we're going to start to decelerate in just a moment. So I'm actually going to set the speed to 250 knots here. Again, this doesn't set the speed at all. It just puts a bug there. It's just for reference, really. And then what we're going to do to slow down is once we hit 12,000 feet, we're going to go to 1,200 feet per minute and just idle the throttles. And we should easily hit 250 knots before we pass through 10,000 feet. So there we go. 12,000 feet, three clicks up and idle throttle. We don't even need 1,200 feet per minute anymore. We only need 1,000 feet per minute. So let's go to 1,000. Okay, and then once we reach Nexo, we are going to go to heading mode. So only 10 miles to go, so I'll need to pay attention to that. Put a bit of power back in and we're looking good. Maybe a little bit low actually. I'm actually going to reduce the descent rate to 500 feet per minute for a short while just to recapture that vertical profile there. There we go. That'll do. Just below the snowflake, but that's absolutely fine. The restriction is below at Nexo anyway. Okay, lock will be tuned. That's good. Not really relevant for us, though, because we're going to be switching to heading mode momentarily. We won't need it to automatically tune. On the plus side, the funky glares are now gone. Yes, they are indeed, yeah. Yeah, no worries at all, Eileen. I'll catch you again soon. Take it easy. Where are we going to? Yep, Copenhagen, Andrea. You tuned in at a fantastic time as well, obviously. We're just actually coming into Copenhagen now. We're on a very shallow descent. It seems like the VNAVs maybe got something a little bit messed up there. All right, so we're approaching Nexo. I'm going to go to heading mode here. Let me just double check there's still no controllers on. Well, there's a tower controller on 118.1, so I'll tune that. I'll have that in the standby, 118.1. And we shall, we're on heading, so we're just going to carry on straight. And I'm just going to vector myself onto the ILS, basically. So we'll continue on present heading for now. And we'll increase that rate of descent to 1,000 feet per minute. Copenhagen traffic, City Island 610 is on approach for runway 22 left. We are approximately 28 miles from the ILS. We're on vectors and we're going to vector ourselves left turn onto the ILS for 22 left. Copenhagen traffic. All right, now I've just realized.
Skyman 602, just behind the aforementioned City Ireland, also on approach for 22 left, self-vectoring after an X, so currently flight level 100 and descending. Castro traffic.
Okay, great stuff. So we've got a colleague who's also doing the same thing. ILS 22 left, I actually had 22 right tuned in. So good thing I picked up on that. And we're fine, we're on vectors here, so no issues at all with that. It's the ILS is at the exact same altitude and we've briefed everything for 22 left. It's just for some reason I had it tuned to 22 right. All right. Let me just double check the frequency again. 109.5. I'm just making sure. Now I'm doubting myself. Yes, I had it in wrong. Okay, cool. So we're looking good now. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of these bearing pointers. We're not doing anything for us anymore now that we're on the ILS. And we'll go ahead and change the nav source to lock one here because we are vectoring ourselves onto the ILS. We're no longer following the flight plan. Record for a replay. Thank you for the reminder, Andrea. Yes, I will make sure I put the replay on. And we've cleared ourselves down to an altitude as well. So I'm going to go ahead and set the local altimeter. Local altimeter on the ATIS is 1032, so we'll set that. And I'm just going to hit B on my keyboard as well, just to make sure that is actually correct and matching up in the sim, which it is. Okay, great stuff. Great stuff. The localizer is not identified just yet, but we should see that probably make an appearance. There we go. Speak of the devil. The course is set to zero. Now, that doesn't actually make a difference when you are flying an ILS in the CRJ, but I am going to set it to 217 just so it makes a bit more sense. So we'll use the course knob here and just set 217. That's set. Okay, I'm going to give myself a turn in towards the airport a little bit here. So we'll go 010, 015 even. All right, great stuff. And I completely forgot to turn the anti-ice on. Hopefully we've not picked up any ice going. I don't think we actually went through any clouds, did we? We actually dodged all the clouds, which is amazing. There's our colleague behind us, the Scandinavian, who's also on the vectors. Not much to see though, unfortunately. We can't quite see the bridge. I think the bridge goes out there, doesn't it? So yeah, oh, you can just make it out. You can just make out the bridge there. And then you can, I think you can just see some runway lights over on that side. Beautiful. Greetings, Claudio from Zurich. Welcome, dude. Hope you're doing well. We've just departed there, actually. Very, very busy, Zurich. Very busy. Right. Okay, so I'm aware I didn't actually draw the MSA in on here, which might have been useful right about now, because we are on sort of self-vectoring here, but I don't think we should be at any risk of going under the MSA. Now, MSA is 1,700, so I don't think we're going to have any issues there at all. Okay, we're going to take a left turn to intercept in just a moment here. Okay, 1,000 to go. Okay, let's turn left. I'm going to give a heading of 280, I think, should do it. It's so dark. I'm going to take these glasses off because it's just reflecting and I can't see anything. Right, we're going to do 290. And I'm going to pick up the pace a bit because this guy behind us, I think, is waiting. I can't, it's so dark, man. It's so dark. Where is he? He should be over there somewhere, but I can't quite see him. I'm going to get the anti-ice on as well because we're going to fly through some clouds here. We'll get the landing lights on and the taxi lights. Probably should have turned them on passing through 10,000, but there we go. Always forget something. Right, so we're on level flight. Once we intercept the ILS, we are going to have about 10 miles, 9.3 in fact, to configure. So we want to start slowing down a bit before then, more or less now really. I'm just going to pull the power back a bit. Let's get the reversers armed as well whilst we're here. Alright, we'll go for speed 220 for now. And we'll give ourselves another little turn here to 265 and we'll arm the approach mode. We've got lock one glide slope in white. Alright, great stuff. Let's go ahead and we're going to turn down the music for the arrival. You have to go soon, Andrea. Oh no. That's unfortunate timing. Well, we're about to land, so if you can stick around for that, let's go ahead and start the replay mode as well. Okay, so localizer's coming in. There we go, lock one. Right, let's go to the tower frequency. Castrop Tower, very good evening. City Island 610, established ILS 22 left.
City Island 610, Castrop Tower, very good evening. Airfield left,
200 degrees, 10 knots. Clear to land 22 left, City Island 610. Okay, landing clearance immediately. Love to see it. Okay, so this is one thing the CRJ does. It turns to intercept the localizer and then it just flies next to it for some reason. So we should get glide slope capture now. There we go, glide slope capture. I'm going to go ahead and get flaps 8 out immediately. Yes, I'm a bit slow on responding there. Let's go performance and set. So we've got our landing speeds in. I'm going to go keep on idle power for now. And let's see if we can see the runway yet. We cannot. Descending a bit quickly here. The glide slope is definitely not that rate of descent. I'm not sure why it's so quick so early. Maybe it'll sort of level out a bit now. We're passing through the final approach fix. Let's go for gear down. Won't be able to see anything. Oh, you could just see the gear coming out there. That's actually really cool, that shot right there. Oh, no. The cloud ruined it. Okay. So, coming through 180 knots, let's go to flaps 20. And we're going to need to get a bit of power in now as we are slowing down quite rapidly. That's the runway right there. What is going on?
SDVI 610, confirm your status for ILS 2 to left.
City Island 610, request visual for 2-2 left.
City Island 610, clear visual 2-2 left and you're still clear to land 200 degrees 10 knots.
Clear for visual 2-2 left and clear to land 2-2 left, City Island 610. Okay, so we're going to go for the visual, guys. Let's go for flaps 30 and I'm going to have to just correct whatever the heck the CIJ has done here.
1,000.
How are we so far off the localizer? That is crazy. This is going to be interesting, guys. This is going to be interesting. We're also way too high. Okay. I don't think we're doing this, guys.
Sink rate.
No, we're not doing this. We're not doing this. City Island 610, I do apologize. We're going around. Follow missed approach procedure and call when established. City Island, City. Terrain. Sorry, go to Unicom and then call when established. City Island 610. Okay, we're going around, guys. We're going around. Okay, let's get the automation back in here. We'll go speed, nav. Why is that not... Why is that mode not... Hello? Okay. We're good. We're already leveled off anyway, so that's why it wouldn't let me do a... Hello? Why is lock one still armed? I don't have the... I don't have approach mode on. What is going on there? Huh. That was bizarre. Okay, so we'll go to flap zero. Okay. I guess we're vectoring ourselves back around. So let's take a left turn here. And we'll go for 220 knots as the speed. Wow. that was interesting. So let's stop the replay there and we'll start again in a minute once we've gone around here. Wow. Okay. That was so strange. Why was it like so far off the localizer? And I was also really high as well. Let me just check the charts here real quick. Make sure I didn't mess up and line up in the... No. We had it all tuned in correctly. Yeah, that's very strange. Very strange. All right, let's keep going round anyway. That go around wasn't too bad though. The issue with the CRJ though is when you're a single pilot is because the go around procedure, because it all happens so quickly, it is very difficult to do everything by the book. But I think it was okay. We didn't overspeed the flaps or gear or anything, so I'm happy with that. 118.1 was the tower frequency. There we go. Okay, cool. Yeah, see, that was the thing, generic pilot. It didn't even line up for 2-2 right either. It wasn't lined up on 2-2 right. It was kind of in between the two runways. It was closer to 2-2 right than... it was closer to 2-2 right than 2-2 left, but it was it didn't line up on 2-2 right. ILS frequency is tuned and correct. Yeah, we've checked that so many times now. 109.5 OXS, and that's what we've got. Sorry, 119.0. Oh my God, I can't speak. 109.5. Oh my God, we haven't got that tuned. Wait, where did we get that frequency from? Yikes. Okay, that's probably my issue there then. Oh, that's rather embarrassing. How many times did we check that? Come on, someone in chat must have seen that and thought this guy's going to get it wrong here. This is going to be funny. 110.9 is 422 right. Wow. Okay. I could have sworn we checked that multiple times. Wow. Okay. That's bizarre. I'm gonna go back into the stream here and just. Actually, we'll do it once we're landed, but I'm going to rewind the stream and just check what's happened there. Because I'm sure we checked that multiple times. Get another view of the bridge? Yeah, hopefully. Maybe the scenery has it the wrong way around. It doesn't, no. No, I've definitely flown into Copenhagen many times before with this scenery. Thomas needs another drink. Oh, you made it down, Chris. Nice, dude. Amazing. Amazing. All right. Let's see if we can do it this time, guys. Let's see. Yeah, guys. The CRJ is trying to cook me here. Oh, I know what's happened. So I did have the ILS frequency tuned correctly previously. I did have it tuned. But I think what happened was, because you guys probably remember, I had 2-2 right tuned by accident on the initial sort of descent when we came down. And you may remember, guys, that it popped up, lock will be tuned here in yellow. So what happened was when that text appeared, because I had 2-2 right in the FMS, basically what that meant was that it even though I had already set the frequency here and set it to manual, it automatically overwrote this frequency that I already tuned in. It overwrote it with the frequency for 2-2 right because that's what it thought I wanted to do. So there you go. That's the answer. That's what happened. We'll go again, though. Let's get VS in because for some reason it's leveled us off at 3,300 when I've definitely selected 3,000 there. Okay, let's try that again, guys. Take two. I think I've had more go-arounds in the CRJ than any other aircraft in this sim. Partially my own fault, but I'm gonna... I'm going to lay some of the blame here on the actual aircraft itself, but that's just me being awkward. We haven't set our minimums either, so we could go ahead and set that now, but I mean, the CRJ doesn't call it out anyway, but let's do it. 210. All right, let's give ourselves an intercept. And we shall arm the approach. So we've got lock one, alt S, and glide slope, alt cap. Yeah, so another reason why I didn't suspect anything was wrong there with the tuning was because it seemed like it was actually trying to line up on 22 left. That was the bizarre thing. When it initially turned in, it looked like it was capturing for 22 left, but as it happened, it wasn't. Okay, so we've got lock one now again. Let's go back to the tower. And we're going to get glide slope capture in just a second here. So we'll get the gear down and we'll go to flaps 8. Okay, there we go. We've got glide slope capture. We're a little bit above the glide slope at the moment. So I'm going to leave power to idle. Kastrup Tower, very good evening. Hello again. City Island 610, established 22 left.
City Island
610,
very good evening again.
To the
left,
headland
wind
200
degrees, 10 knots.
Clear to land 22 left, City Island 610. Great stuff. Well, as you can see, guys, the localizer is still not exactly flying on the localizer, which is a bit worrying, but it. The runway definitely looks more in front of us this time than it did last time, so I'm feeling a bit more confident this time. Right, so 170 knots, let's go to flaps 20. Add in a bit of thrust here just to slow that rate of deceleration down a bit. Love how chilled out the ATC sounds. Yeah, that guy sounded very chilled out, didn't he? Bit different to how I'm feeling right now. Okay, so 160 knots, flaps 30. Let's go ahead and stick in our VREF once again. VREF is 132. Okay, so it looks like we're good to land this time. So flight attendants are advised, passenger signs are on, thrust reversers are armed, landing gear is down, flaps is going to be 40. Landing checklist complete. So we've got 4 miles to go. Let's go for flaps 40 now. It's so dark outside. I hope Microsoft Flight Simulator doesn't do that bug where the runway lights just disappear on me. Right, so let's disconnect, and I'm going to put the disconnect bar up. That's what cooked me as well on the go-around before. All right, it's very, very difficult to see those lights, so I'm just going to follow the flight directors for now.
1,000.
Autopilot is disconnected. This is manual flight. We've got 15 knots, more or less straight down the runway of wind. Got two whites, two reds currently. We're a little bit left of center line, so I'm just correcting for that. 750 feet above ground level.
Five hundred feet
is checked. My voice is going croaky.
400.
Please don't disappear, lights.
Sink rate.
Sink rate is checked.
100. 50, 40, 30, 20, 10.
Woof! We're down. I think we sideloaded it a little bit there, but we're fine. Ground spoilers are deployed. We've got full reverse in. And manual braking, 60 knots. Great stuff. Here we are. We made it. I think this is a taxiway on the right. Can't see a thing though. It's so difficult to see. Wait. Oh, it is, but we passed it. Let's carry on going. All right, we finally got there in the end. That wasn't a bad landing either. It wasn't too bad, was it? I think I sideloaded it a little bit because I floated a bit longer than what I wanted to there. And I ended up having to put in a bit of extra rudder to get the nose down the middle of the runway. But not too bad. Let's get the spoilers up then. And flight directors can come off now. We do have the anti-ice on.
6101, welcome to Copenhagen. Taxi band Echo 84 via Bravo, Romeo, Whiskey and Tango, cross on the 30.
Thank you very much. Could we request stand Bravo 15, City Island 610?
City Island 610, Bravo 15 is occupied at the moment. Do you want Bravo 16 instead?
Sure, we'll take Bravo 16. Taxi Bravo 16 via Bravo and Yankee, cross runway 30, City Island 610, thank you. Alright, let's get the taxi light off and the landing lights off as well. We'll leave the nose light on so we have at least a little bit of visibility out the front. The lights are really not good at all on the CRJ. We'll turn the strobe light off as well. And we'll turn the probe heat off as well as the anti-ice. So this is Bravo here. There's not much to see, but it is Bravo. What we'll do is we'll go ahead and stop the replay. Oh no, I didn't start the replay. God damn it. God damn it, guys. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, guys. I completely forgot to start the replay.
Nordlight 3518, Castle Tower, very good evening. You're cleared to London and Gatwick. Lango 1, Foxbot, departure, runway 2 to left. Score 1233.
Yeah, I'm a bit gutted now. We're not going to be able to see the replay of that, but never mind. Alright, let's do the after landing checklist. So, APU, we'll turn that on now as well. So, APU on. And we'll start it. I'm just using a keybind for that. Transponder is set. We'll leave that on until we get to the stand. Slats and flaps are zero. Lights are set. Probes are off after landing check is complete. All right then. Guys, what do you reckon? What do you reckon out of 10 for that landing? And be honest. I can take the criticism. Go on, hit me up. It's so dark. Well, that wasn't bad landing, I suppose. It was very smooth, though. 76 feet per minute. I'll take that. So I'm not paying attention to where I'm going here. So Bravo and Yankee. I think I might have just missed the turning for Yankee because I'm really not paying attention at all here. No, I haven't. Okay, that's good. So yeah, we're crossing the runway and then taking a left, second left onto Yankee and then down to Bravo 16, which is right there on the corner. I think someone else he said was already on Bravo 15. Okay, so the APU has started up.
NCTRN 610, Castle Tower.
City Island 610 ready to copy.
City Island 610, stand bar 15 is now free, so if you want, you can take stand bar 15.
Wilco, thank you very much. Yep, so Bravo 15 and same taxi instructions to the Island 610. Okay, great stuff. We get our stand of choice now. So this is the actual stand that this real flight actually ended up at. So very, very nice. 8 out of 10 for me. It's been a nice flight. Thank you very much, Will. That's very generous. ILS programming score 0, landing score 9. Oh, I love it. That's a good... I like that. I like the breakdown there. I like the breakdown. But the replay wasn't on, Thomas. I'm so annoyed at that. I'm so annoyed. Strobe lights on as we're passing, crossing a runway here. You can see runway 30. Looking clear. And we're straight across. Let's turn the strobe lights off. And we're going to take a second left here on to Yankee. So we're on Bravo. Left is Zulu. And then the next left should be Yankee. There we go. Yankee to the left.
Left touch for one. Is ready for pushing start. Left is 7-1. Putting battle proof to face east. QNH 1-0.
I am glad I went around there, though. I am glad I went around because, guys... How many of you took a really sort of deep breath or like swallowed hardly when I was like, request the visual for 2-2 left? When I was clearly too high and clearly too far away. Oh dear, that could have ended so badly. Yo, Bill, thank you for the 100 stars as well, dude. Much appreciated. 8.5 out of 10. I would be a happy passenger. Amazing. Glad to hear it. I think it might have felt... I mean, it definitely wouldn't have been a hard landing in the cabin, but you might have felt the right gear touch first, maybe. Okay, so we're going to go Bravo 15, which is one of these stands right here. It's quite difficult to see. That's Bravo 19 there. There should be some ground markings as well for Bravo 15. Can't see the markings. It's so dark. I know Bravo 15 is somewhere. Let's just turn the lights on for a second here. Bravo 15, you can just make it out there. Oh my god. Right, cool. Right, let's turn all the lights off anyway so we don't blind the ground crew. And we'll take a sharp right in here. Hello? There we go, we're moving. Disadvantage to turning the lights off is I can't see a thing. Please, we need marshallers in this sim or some kind of visual docking guidance system. Bravo 15, oh, it's over here to the right. All right, great stuff. All right, there we go. Nice. Now, I was actually looking this up earlier on, what these lines mean, these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I couldn't find anywhere that told me what those lines actually mean. I know in some airports you get the type of aircraft or you get the category of the aircraft, but I can't find anything relating to this. If anyone knows, I would love to know. All right, there we go. We are on stand. APU is running. Let's just check the electric page. It's So we've got the APU running. It's not taking any load at the moment. So what we'll do is we'll go ahead and stop the left-hand engine, as would normally be done on stand here with the CRJ. Normally, you would also get ground power connected rather than going for an APU. But we've got the APU today, so we'll use it. And we'll go ahead and shut down engine 2. So there we go. APU generator taking the full load there. We'll go to the aircraft page. We'll get the chocks put in and the ground power card connected. We'll open the passenger door and the forward cargo. Lights are on in the cabin. Turn the beacon light off. Fuel boost pumps off. Packs off. Recirculation fan off. Seatbelt signs can come off as well. Isolation valve can go to closed. And we are more or less, we're more or less here. Let's get the baggage on the way. There they are. We're just going to ignore them as they glitch through the plane right now. Okay, cool, cool, cool. We'll turn the standby radio off. We'll turn the IRSs both to the off position. And let's do a parking checklist. So shutdown checklist, parking brake is set, seatbelts are off, thrust levers are shut off, anti-ice is off, fuel pumps are off, beacon light is off, nose wheel steering is off. Shutdown checklist complete. There we go. We've got the baggage coming in here. We've got the door open. Love to see it. I imagine that if you parked at this stand, you would probably walk into the terminal, right? You would probably walk up this staircase and into this door here, I imagine. Oh, I'm a bit gutted I didn't record that replay now. Anyways, let's have a look at the landing report then on Sim Toolkit Pro. Oh, yo, Daniel. It's a Castrop Tower. Amazing, dude. I did a great job. Oh, thank you very much. Thank you very much. I don't know if you saw the stream before on my initial approach. That was going to be a big yikes, but I think we managed to make it work in the end. But yeah, thank you very much for the great ATC, dude. We've had some great ATC on this trip today, so yeah, thank you. All right, let's have a look at the landing report anyway on Sim Toolkit. So should be quite favorable, I hope. Let's see. All right, so we got minus 76 feet per minute, 1.01 g, so pretty good really on the landing rate. In terms of speed, VREF speed was 132 knots. We landed at 122 knots, so yeah, that's probably blame the I overflared basically. I think that's why we floated a bit. But let's see where we actually touched down. That's the important thing, isn't it? See how much we actually floated. So I don't think we actually floated that far. I think it was quite decent. Oh, that was actually pretty good. So we're right in the touchdown zone there, only 500 feet after the 1,000-foot markers. So well within the touchdown zone. Now, obviously we touched. Hang on, let me just. There we go. So yeah, obviously we touched down right of center line here, which is not the greatest, but we pointed the nose inwards to the runway and we managed to rectify our center line tracking once we actually had touched the ground. So I'll take that. Landing distance good, landing rate good, center line tracking not so great, but I think we did get we got blown a little bit as we were floating. So I don't know necessarily if it was centerline tracking that was the issue there. It was more my flare technique. I think that was the issue there. But there we go. We're here at Copenhagen. Love to see it. Someone said the 747 looks weird at Copenhagen. Yeah, I can see what you mean, but it doesn't look too bad. It is just a fairly low... It is a fairly low res, just static model though, isn't it? I don't think they're going to put too much time into it. It is what it is. Where are we? Let's see. Can we get a nice little bit of this going on? There we go. Fantastic. Gin and tonic wobbled a little bit on landing. I'm not surprised. Where's the ramp crew? Oh, they're here now. They're here now. Sometimes they take a while to arrive. Well, appreciate your ratings anyway, guys. I thought that was quite a decent turnout to what's been an extremely eventful stream, actually. So thank you very much if you've just tuned in for the first time today. And if you've dropped a sub or a like on this stream, really, really appreciate that. Yeah, really, really kind of you. Thank you so much. Let's see what else we've got here. Instead of having all the aircraft types, you have a sheet at the head of the stand that lists the types and is given number 1 to 5. Ah, right, okay. Fair enough. Okay, great stuff. Well, I guess, obviously, in a real scenario, you have a marshaller, so they obviously know to where to tell you to stop, I guess. I suppose in flight simulation, the issue is we don't always have that, so, yeah, hence my question mark on the matter. But, yeah, that makes a lot of sense. That makes a lot of sense. Yeah, makes sense, Neil. Thank you very much for that. Really appreciate that. That's very interesting. Manicle, thank you, dude, for tuning in and for your £3 tip. I really appreciate that, dude. Very generous, as always. Annie Balisic, thank you very much for the sub on YouTube. But there we go, guys. I'm going to leave it there for this stream. It's been emotional. No, it's been great fun today, and yeah, I hope you guys have enjoyed it nevertheless. I certainly have, and thank you very much for tuning in once again. Oh, you're ops at Heathrow, so I've done a bit of marshalling over the years. Nice, Neil, nice. Amazing, dude. That's really cool. Well, thank you very much for tuning in anyway. Everybody, really appreciate your support today. If you're on your way out and you enjoyed the content and you haven't already, do hit the thumbs up button. Really, really appreciate that. Big help for the stream. So thank you so much once again. Hope you guys have a fantastic rest of your evening. Everybody who's tuned in, all my regulars as well, big love to you guys. And thank you so much for tuning in. I'll see you in the next one, and bye-bye for now.